ago to do national anthem.
Yeah. We encourage fans to enthusiasm and support their team, recognize outstanding performance of opponents, and always exhibit instant sportsmanship in their words and actions.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Trust Farm Parade for tonight's contest between the Christian Brothers University Buccaneers and your University of Montalbano Falcons. At this time, we ask that you please join us as we honor America with the flames of our national anthem.
Seven are dressed out. That's crazy. All right, we ready?
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome tonight's starters, beginning with the Buccaneers.
Hello and welcome into Trustmark Arena. I'm Wyatt Hall, joined by my partners Brett Batchelor and Connor Ryan as we get set up for this Gulf South Conference matchup between the Montevallo Falcons and the visiting Christian Brothers Buccaneers. Montevallo returns to Trustmark Arena 8-6 on the season. The Buccaneers come in at 5-7. Guys, what do we have to look forward to in this matchup today?
Well, I think on the Falcons side, first, you have to look at our roster. It's just a lot deeper than the Christian Brothers team. Christian Brothers only bringing in seven players to play. And with that, the Falcons, you have Nautica Philpott leading with averaging 14 points a game. Falcons are averaging right now 63 points a game, and they're on a four-home game win streak right now, so I think they're looking really good right now at home.
Yeah, undefeated at home so far, and Christian Brothers are trying to throw them in here today. And Brett, if the Buccaneers want to do that, what do they have to do?
A 5'6" sophomore guard from Auburn, Alabama, number 10, Nautica Philpott.
It's super quiet. I didn't hear what you asked.
If the Buccaneers want to get a victory today, what do they have to do?
Well, if you come into this game, the Falcons have a big size advantage over the Buccaneers. So the Buccaneers are going to have to play a lot of perimeter basketball and find ways to move around the Falcons' defense rather than pushing it inside throughout the entire basketball game.
All right, let's take a look at the starters. First for the visiting Buccaneers. Starting at guard is Rachel Lee, Sarah Owen, Kinsey Jones, and Bryn Little. And the lone forward is Michaela Enox. The head coach for Christian Brothers is Sarah Condry. And for the home Falcons, starting as Paige Ward, Nautica Philpott, Kai Sane in the backcourt, and the forwards are Courtney Smith and Aaliyah Rice. And we mentioned depth, kind of an issue for Christian Brothers in this game. So is height. They start four guards and only one forward, and that being Michaela Enox, who's just 5'9".
The Falcons themselves starting two players that are over 5'10", so if you're the Falcons here, the Falcons have done better this year about getting the ball inside, and that's what you have to continue to do in this game is push it down low, especially with the big size advantage.
And we have seen the Falcons crash the glass all season long. They've been one of the best teams in the Gulf South Conference in rebounding, and we know that they can score well in the paint with Aaliyah Rice and Courtney Smith, so we should see that on display here today. Smith will face off for the jump ball between Enochs and comes up in the hands of Philpott. Montevallo in the white jerseys, Christian Brothers in the black.
Good recovery by Philpott there.
Quickly inside to Smith. Swing it to the perimeter, and Rice will drive inside. Floater is good, so first buckets for the Falcons are in the paint. Christian Brothers the other way now. In the corner to Enochs. She kicks out top of the key to Rachel Lee. Driving inside, loses it, gets it back. Layup no good. Courtney Smith gets the rebound.
Good rebound by Smith right there. You can really think that she's been a very crucial element for them on the glass this season.
Inside to Rice again, kicks out to Ward. In the corner, Philpott had a lot of time there, but decided to not take the three-pointer. Inside, Rice again, kisses it off the glass.
Going inside quick is exactly what we talked about before the game, for the Falcons go up 4-0.
A quick three-pointer on the way in transition, no good. A rebound to Sane. And with a small lineup, if Christian Brothers wants to have a chance in this game, they're going to have to shoot well from beyond the arc.
Mm.
In the corner again to Philpott. She tries it this time. Rims out. Smith can't get the rebound. Goes in the hands of the Buccaneers the other way.
This is another thing that Christian Brothers will have to do well all game. Being a little bit smaller, they have to play good transition basketball to get back down past the Falcons on offense.
I agree. And you can see that they recognize both the height and numbers difference because they're in a zone right now.
Enochs misses that three, Falcons ball. 4-0 here, 8:30 to go in the first. Rice from the elbow is good. Aaliyah Rice has 6 points very quickly.
Aaliyah Rice is that one player that she's going to get your average minutes for that you would expect out of a good player, but she's one that you cannot have get in foul trouble. We've seen it so far at times throughout this season where she's gotten in foul trouble and it's hurt the teams, but when she's not in foul trouble, she's a huge player down low.
Philpott driving inside, can't get that to go. Rebound in the hands of the Buccaneers. Trap over here in the corner. Somehow gets out of it, does Kinsey Jones. Layup no good inside. Falls into the hands of Bryn Little. Resets the offense of the Buccaneers. And Rachel Lee knocks down the three-pointer.
Christian Brothers are really aggressive starting out in this prep.
Yeah, last time the Falcons broke it with a jumper from Aaliyah Rice, and now Paige Ward will try a three.
Good
Courtney
rebound
Smith
there. Good.
Can't get the follow, but Christian Brothers swinging it around the perimeter. Enochs in the corner. Her three no good. Goes out of bounds off of Bryn Little. I thought it went off Courtney Smith there, but
that's exactly what we talked about though before the game. Is Christian Brothers playing a lot of perimeter
right
basketball because
mm-hmm.
they know they can't get it inside, and pretty much almost all of their shots have either come from right next to or behind the arc throughout the game so far.
And eventually throughout the game, you think that they'll be able to create enough space on the floor to get those open lanes to the basket from shooting all those threes as Aaliyah Rice gets another layup. 8 points for her already. An offensive foul. Kaya Sane draws the offensive foul for the Falcons, and Montevallo is executing everywhere on the floor
so far.
The Falcons
just, they came into this game, they just seem real comfortable. I understand that they're coming off two straight losses, but they just seem comfortable moving through the press, moving through the zone defense, and taking smart shots.
Hey, Ward fires up a three and makes it in transition. So far, the press hasn't really been working.
No.
And that right there, when you have a player like Aaliyah Rice who's put up 8 points so far, they're going to have to crash down low sooner or later. And that's when you're able to get it out to somebody like Paige Ward who can make the threes throughout the game.
Enochs with it now. Kicks it out to Jones. Inside. Nice cut from Little, and she is fouled on her layup attempt. So she'll go to the line for two shots. It's Courtney Smith who commits the foul.
First personal team foul, number one. Shooting two for Christian Brothers, number 22, Bryn Little.
First free throw was good from Little. And we talk about Paige Ward, you know, her ability to shoot the three in the West Florida game. She hit 5 3-pointers in that game.
Mm.
And Paige Ward is somebody that's really come in, and last year she was a little bit of a role player. She's taken a bigger role this year on this basketball team, and it's proven that she's earned it by the year that she's having so far.
Rice inside to Smith. Smith has it stripped. Rachel Lee comes up with it. This is Little driving inside of the wing. Kick out. Three-pointer on the way from Christian Brothers. Rolls off the rim. That was a three-pointer by Sarah Owen.
Christian Brothers getting that steal, though. That's one thing that they do very well so far this season. I mean, they're averaging almost 9 steals per game. That's how they create some of their offense, even though they're a small ball type of team.
It's interesting to see how fast they're playing when they do make those steals, too. They're just right down the floor and trying to those fast break transitions.
Just like we saw Nautica Philpott hit the elbow jumper, which is something
good pass right there.
Loves to do.
Great pass.
That looks good.
Montevallo executing everywhere so far. 15-5, and to be honest, I don't think I've seen them play a game like this season.
This is honestly, I would have to agree, this is the most free-flowing I've seen the team so far. Nobody's uptight. Nobody's stressed. It just seems like they came in with a good game plan that everybody was comfortable with knowing what they wanted to do.
And it seems kind of odd. Christian Brothers only traveled 7, but they come off a victory against West Alabama on Thursday. And West Alabama is a team that is in the mid-level of the conference. So, they come off a win there and then only bring 7 this game, and so far it's not looking good, 15-5.
Speaking of conference games, the Falcons coming off of 2 losses. One of them was a conference loss that put them to 4-2 in the conference. But the Falcons only have a half game lead over 5 other teams in the conference right now. So if the Falcons were able to pull out this win, this would be a huge conference game. And a win right here would only get them 1 full game back of 3rd place in the conference as well.
All right, well, we will step away for a few moments for the remainder of the media timeout. Stay with us here on Not a Valor for You.
Can y'all hear me?
Yeah.
I can't hear myself very well.
It's quieter than what it was pregame.
Okay, but you can hear me.
Yeah, I can hear you. Okay. Yeah, I can't hear myself super well, but if y'all can.
Turn it back on. Back after the media timeout, it's Christian Brothers basketball. Owen with it, guarded by Paige Ward on the perimeter. Back to the top of the key to Lee. See what Christian Brothers drew up after the timeout. Layup no good from Little.
Good rebound there by Ward.
Turn it!
Rice has position inside. Philpott gives it top of the key to Smith, swings it in the corner to Ward, who will try a 3.
That was good.
Ward knocks down the 3-pointer.
Falcons have done a fantastic job so far this game about finding the open player around the court, whether it be inside or on the perimeter, whatever they can do to make the extra pass to make it an easier shot.
You can tell that the passing game is very important to them. Right now you can hear Coach Venata on the side, just one more pass, look to the next man open. So.
And protecting the ball is a big emphasis in today's game as Kaya Sane forces a turnover and converts it into a layup on the other end.
We talked about Christian Brothers averaging 9 steals a game, but the Falcons themselves average 8 steals a game.
Right.
So both of these teams very aggressive on defense, but trying to create defense into offense.
Top of the key, Kenzie Jones, a leading scorer for the Buccaneers, gives it off to Rachel Lee, who tries a 3-pointer. Long rebound to Sarah Owen for an extra possession for the Buccaneers here. Inside to Enix. Gets it to Little at the elbow, who will drive inside through the contact of Aaliyah Rice. Gets the jumper. 13-point lead still for the Falcons, 20-7. Kaya Sane tries a 3.
That was good.
Kaya Sane.
Defense, let's go. Who's down?
Falcons shooting very well from the floor so far here.
It's one of the
first quarter.
Better outside perimeter games I've seen this season.
And most of the three-point shots they've taken have been wide open three-pointers. Both that Paige Ward took and then that one that Kaya Sane took. So they're doing a very good job of spacing the floor.
It's just exciting overall watching this game and just thinking back to last season and how things didn't necessarily go as planned in a lot of ways, and just seeing the Falcons really get that chemistry and that turnover over.
And number 23, Jordan Jones.
Jordan
Jordan Jones checks in for the Falcons here, so does Cheyenne Flack.
With Kaya saying checking out right there, you'd think that maybe we would see a little bit more from Nautica Philpott. She's the leading scorer, and she hasn't really had anything yet today, which isn't a problem because the Falcons are doing a good job at moving the ball, but you just expect to see her involved in the offense a little bit more here sooner.
But you might also see, as the lead increases, her trying to use Coach Bonata trying to use that to just use players that haven't really had as much playing time and see who can, you know, do things in this game. So,
and a turnover there committed by the Falcons. Jordan Jones just throws it away there, and that's something we haven't seen so far in this game. A team that averages 18 turnovers a game has protected the ball fairly well today, and because of that, Mackenzie Lane at the free throw line for the Buccaneers, shooting two shots. This is the first, makes the second, 23-8. Phil Propp brings it across half court for the Falcons here.
Look at her. Look at her.
See if Montevideo continues to move the ball. Paige Ward will try
another
three.
Good.
That's good.
Paige Ward's having a fantastic game so far.
Three of three from beyond the arc is Ward. She had five made three-pointers against West Florida for 15 points.
I don't know if y'all saw, but that defense right there from Jordan Jones looked very good. It's very aggressive. High. I like seeing defense like that. High top of the key pressure to the point guard.
Christian Brothers is trying to create a lot more off-ball screens now throughout the middle of the zone to try and create some sort of offense they can get because they haven't got found any at all so far in the quarter.
And at the end of the shot clock, a blocking foul called against Paige Ward. But that was a great defensive possession for the Falcons.
Christian
Brothers had really nothing to go inside, no lanes. At the free throw line is Lauren Taylor. Misses the first.
Number 30, Deja
Mark checks in now for Montevallo. Paige Ward will get a breather. Three fouls for the Falcons here in the first quarter, just one committed by Christian Brothers. And Taylor knocks down the second, 26-9.
That is one of the only things Christian Brothers does have going for them right now is that seems like a lot of fouls have been called against them.
Smith can't convert the layup. Rebound, Cheyenne Flack. Nautica Philpott will try a three. Can't knock it down. Rebound to Christian Brothers.
3-1 advantage here.
And a nice hesitation move from Bryn Little, but she can't convert the layup. And
good.
Nautica Philpott going the other way.
Great
here.
Handles
nice
there, and a good pass.
Pass
to great play right by Nautica there. Philpott right there.
That was a fantastic pass from Philpott. Mackenzie Lane, a transition three-pointer.
A good response there from Christian Brothers.
Passes like that, though, from Nautica Philpott are the reasons why she's the team assist leader as well.
Mm-hmm.
Fighting for position inside. They won't give it to her. They'll keep it outside the perimeter. Gets deflected out of bounds. But it'll remain Montevallo basketball. A minute 30 left in the first quarter. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Philpott on the outside. Trying to get
great pass
the
again.
Pass.
And converts
the
layup.
Fantastic pass.
This has got to be the best quarter the team has played all season long.
Yeah. I don't think that they passed the ball as well at any point during the season as they have so far today.
No. Nautica's just been able to find different open mans and just great passes. So
another three-pointer by the Buccaneers. 15-point game. But it has been a stellar first quarter offensively for the Falcons. 30 points. Courtney Smith working in the paint. Her layup no good. Cheyenne Flack got the rebound. We got a strip by Kenzie Jones. Rachel Lee, layup no good. Courtney Smith, the rebound.
Falcons are doing a really good job at not going for the Christian Brothers' hesitations of going up for the layups and not getting called for fouls.
Nautica Philpott fouled on the other end. She'll go to the line for two. And Philpott, a very good free throw shooter, at shooting 78% on the season from the line.
Shooting two for Montevallo, number 10, Nautica Philpott.
First free throw is good from Philpott. A couple subs coming in for the Falcons. Savannah Lee and Kaya Sane. And then Michaela Enix coming back in for the Buccaneers. Savannah Lee, another one of those talented freshmen for Montevallo this season and provide some more height.
That's exactly what I was going to say. She's somebody else that you can throw the ball down low. Because when you don't have somebody like Aaliyah Ryson, she's a perfect fit to throw back in there.
3 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock here as we wind down in the first. Lauren Taylor with it over to Little. To Mackenzie Lane, guarded heavily by Kaya Sane here. In the corner to Little, she'll try a contested three-pointer air ball. Cheyenne Flack gets a rebound. Nautica Philpott with 9 seconds to go in the first quarter. Kaya Sane will try three.
Good, that's good.
Kaya Sane again.
Didn't get it off.
And that won't count. 35-15 after the first quarter. An excellent offensive first quarter from the Falcons.
You can't ask for anything better than that right there. Every single shot was about wide open. And the shots that weren't wide open, they found a way to find the open player, whether it be throwing it down inside or passing it back out to the outside.
And if you're Christian Brothers, what do you do to try and cut into this 20-point deficit going into the second?
It's tough to say right now. I think that they're definitely going to have to call off that press. I think the press, they just,
yeah.
Especially with only having 7 players on the team, that's a bit too much just energy being taken out right there. And
I think the idea with that was they had a lot of guards on the floor.
Right.
They thought that they could use speed to their advantage in a way, running the full court press, but Montevallo kept finding ways to break that.
That's one of the biggest things that we've seen so far is we knew the height differential would be bad for Christian Brothers. But even the speed, the Falcons have outrun Christian Brothers the entire game, pushing the ball down the floor. And even when Christian Brothers has gotten steals and try and move the ball in transition, the Falcons have gotten back in on defense as well and not allowed them to create easy shots off of turnovers.
If I were them, though, I would cut back to a 2-1-2 zone, let them try to, give the Falcons that ability to try to shoot from the outside more than rather than getting the ball inside.
If they're able to cut back to that 2-1-2 zone, you're exactly right. They can be able to try and cut off those outside shots because that's what the Falcons have
been able
to find them all day. Mm-hmm. So you're going to have to force the Falcons to try and make some bad passes rather than having open jump shots.
And we get set for the second quarter of play. For the Falcons, 9 points from Paige Ward. She leads all scores. 8 each from Aaliyah Rice and Kaya Sane. Mackenzie Lane will try another three-pointer. That one no good. Nautica Philpott comes up with the rebound.
Good look there.
Ahead to Marsh. And Marsh gets the layup in transition. 37-15.
We go right back to the height differential now. The Falcons now have Savannah and Aaliyah both playing down low, which adds even more of a bigger height differential so they can pass it down low if they have to.
And a steal from Kaya Sane. And the first layup, no good in transition, just trying to be fancy there on that one. But Bryn Little tries a jumper from the free throw line. Nautica Philpott the rebound.
Christian Brothers has not been able to find anything on offense at all yet. Even if they found the open shots, they're still not getting them to fall.
A nice pass from Nautica Philpott as Savannah Lee gets the layup, and we'll have another timeout taken by Coach Condra as the Falcons lead 39-15 here in the second.
We talked about Nautica not necessarily being involved in the offense, but she's still been involved with the ball at the top of the key. Without shots, though, even without the ball, setting up screens, being able to find the open player for shots. Even though she's not really on the stat sheet, she's been a huge key to the Falcons' 39 points
so
far.
Well, she's doing exactly what a point guard needs to do. She's creating the offense, and that's, I think, we can see again and again. There's every single pass is either every pass is from her assist, rather, or it's two passes, and so she's definitely setting us up in a good place right now.
We know how good of a scorer Nautica Philpott is.
For sure.
And how dynamic of a scorer she can be, but I think we often forget how good of a passer she also is. She's averaging 3.8 assists on the season. She already has 5.
Right.
We haven't even played a quarter and a half.
No.
So I'm sure we'll see a lot more of that going forward. But really, if you're Christian Brothers, you've got to find some sort of answer defensively. But to be honest, I don't know what that is.
I don't either.
To be honest with you, I don't know if they know what it is either yet. Because they can't run in transition. They definitely can't stop the down low ball. And whatever defense they've tried to run so far has not stopped the perimeter shot either. So if you're the coach over there, you have to try and think of something. And honestly, it might have to be at halftime. And you just try and not let the lead grow any bigger in the second quarter.
Yeah. And at some point, you have to think about the fact you only have 7 players. So you have to be careful.
Exactly.
You don't want to get any of your players in foul trouble.
You can't get in foul trouble.
You only have 7.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll see what Coach Condra drew up after the timeout. 39-15 the lead for the Falcons. It'll be Christian Brothers ball. Enix, nice pass inside. Kenzie Jones gets a left-handed layup.
That one right there really just came from Nautica Philpott going after that steal and losing her man.
Turn it!
Philpott in the corner to Marsh inside. Aaliyah Rice. Nice move from Rice. Reverse layup.
Good reverse layup there.
Wow. Aaliyah Rice is dominating so far today. 10 points.
That's a good steal back right there. Take that the other way.
And that was just an errant pass from Christian Brothers. Turns into a steal from Marsh. Savannah Lee inside.
Good move right there.
And Lee commits the offensive foul. And that was a good call from the official. Just a little bit of an elbow there from Lee.
That's where you have to be careful, too, though, if you're the Falcons, because just because you have such of a big height differential, you're going to be able to overpower it down low. Mm-hmm. So when you get a little too aggressive, it's going to be an easy call every time.
Yeah, for sure.
Enix with it on the elbow. Mackenzie Jones. Jones thought about a three, but will flip it inside to Enix, and that was a nice play. Enix set
very good
screen,
play.
But Rice knew what was coming and jumped it, and that left Enix wide open for the layup. To 19. Falcons leading here in the second. Rice inside to Lee, stolen by Enix. And Christian Brothers going the other way quickly. Rachel Lee. Kick back out. Kenzie Jones to try a three. Off the front iron. Aaliyah Rice to rebound.
Ooh.
Rice dribbles between her legs. And nice behind the head pass to Lee, who gets
there it
the
is.
Layup.
What a play.
Aaliyah Rice is showing out today.
Aaliyah's having a great time. I don't know if you saw it on the last one, but down here she's smiling while she's guarding on ball. And then she comes up with the rebound and takes it down coast to coast herself.
And you love that if your coach been out of your team playing well and having fun while they do it.
Mm-hmm.
Grim Little, a three-pointer is good.
Aaliyah Rice is still smiling, too. That smile has not come off of her face.
Rice, 10 points here in today's game, also has two assists.
Good look by Nautica there.
Lee on the perimeter. Hand off, Nautica Philpott going inside, and they're going to call a moving screen against Savannah Lee.
That's two quick fouls on Savannah.
Yeah, so she'll have to come to the bench. Courtney Smith will come in, as well as Cheyenne Cunningham for making her first appearance in today's game, 48 Marsh. Mackenzie Lane comes in for Christian Brothers, and so does Lauren Taylor. Little on the wing, guarded by Cunningham here.
Christian Brothers with a lot of off-ball movement moving throughout the zone.
Cunningham
good defense.
Pokes it away, but can't come up with the ball cleanly. So he has to slow it down here and wait for the offense to establish themselves. Finds Aaliyah Rice. Not like a Philpott thought about a three. Will drive inside, lose the ball. Michaela Enix gets the steal. Cunningham right behind her, but Enix able to convert the layup.
That was good defense by Christian Brothers right there.
Christian Brothers starting to cut into this lead a little bit here, 43-24. Saying out to Rice. Rice bounce pass inside to Courtney Smith, who had position on Enix and is fouled. So Smith will go to the line to shoot two. And all season long, watching the chemistry that Aaliyah Rice and Courtney Smith is amazing. Aaliyah Rice really knows how to feed the ball to Smith in the post.
And that's one thing that you love to have out of one of your bigs like that right there. If you have somebody that can – I mean, we saw her go between the legs earlier going coast to coast, and then she has good looks when she's even down low going from one side of the court to the other. So if you have somebody that can do that, that can play down low like Aaliyah does, that's huge for your offense.
One of one from the line is Smith. Back to a 20-point game with 5:50 to go before halftime. Enix with it on the elbow.
Good
nice
look
pass
there.
To Kenzie Jones, who gets the layup.
This is where, if you're the Falcons, you have an 18-point lead here, but you still can't fall asleep because this is not a bad Christian Brothers team. The Falcons are just playing very well. So you can't fall asleep on defense, and you can't start making bad passes and bad shots on offense as well.
Kai Sane, three-pointer no good. Enoch's the rebound ahead. Bryn Little hits the underside of the rim. Cheyenne Cunningham comes up with the board. And we continue to see Christian Brothers just very sloppy on those transition possessions, trying to get something very quickly instead of taking what's best. Cunningham, hand off to Sane. 9 seconds on the shot clock. Inside, Courtney Smith. Smith kick out, Aaliyah Rice, long two-pointer on the way, no good. And a foul against Courtney Smith. She was battling with Enochs for the rebound, pushed her in the back.
First foul, 13. Second personal team foul.
That's 30. The second on Courtney Smith, so that'll be something to keep an eye on going forward.
Yeah, I wonder if Coach Fanata is going to decide to take her out.
Yeah, we see Cheyenne Flat come to the sideline here, so I'm sure next dead ball she'll sub in for Courtney.
Jordan Jones also coming in.
Jones with it on the perimeter for the Buccaneers here. Enochs with it now. Back to Jones for Chaya. Wide open three-pointer. No good. Smith the rebound.
Good rebound there by Smith.
Philpott driving baseline. Gets through the defenders. Can't get the reverse layup. Courtney Smith there for the rebound. And tries a couple times. Can't get it to go. And will go out of bounds off of the Falcons.
The reverse layup has been a big thing for us today. I don't know. It hasn't been too successful, but seems to be something that they're kind of trying around with.
So Jordan Jones and Cheyenne Flat come in for Courtney Smith and Kaya Sane. 4:12 left to go in the second quarter here. Lauren Taylor with it. Out to Jones. Drives by the screen of Taylor. Kicks out to Enochs in the wing. And goes out of Taylor, out of bounds off of Rice, actually. I thought it was off of Christian Brothers initially, but Rice got a piece of it there. Lane inbound for the Buccaneers.
Good defense right there.
Yeah, Leah Rice just knocking it out of bounds there, and so they'll have to inbound again. Over to Jones. Looked like she had a good look from three, but decides to not take it. We'll kick out to Enochs with four on the shot clock.
Gotta find a shot.
Jones with one on the clock and just barely hits the rim there. Philpott with the rebound and going the other way quickly.
I don't know if they even knew until the end that the shot clock was going down.
Nautica Philpott gets it to roll in, and she is so dangerous in transition.
Mm-hmm. She really is. And just to be able to have multiple players on the offense to be able to score at any time in the game is what you really need.
She's so quick, and she's one of the smaller players on the court. I feel like she almost can just, like, weave through people when going down on a fast break, and layup is in transition.
Cheyenne Flack, wide open baseline jumper, no
long.
Good. Jordan Jones trying to come up with the rebound, has it go off of her out of bounds to Christian Brothers basketball. Substitutes for both sides. Jennifer Andrew comes in for the Falcons. Her first appearance in today's game, and Sarah Owen checks back in for Christian Brothers. Kenzie Jones inside Lauren Taylor. Great defense from the Falcons here, just not allowing anything easy. Enochs spins, and layup is good from Michaela Enochs. 46-28. Go. 2.5 minutes to go here in the second quarter. Montevallo leading Christian Brothers 46-28. Jordan Jones will try a jumper from the free throw line. No good there. Sarah Owen the rebound for Christian Brothers.
The Falcons have been forcing the ball a little bit too much on the offense the last few possessions.
They seem to be getting a little complacent.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Which is something you don't want if you're Coach Fanata. Jordan Jones commits a foul right in front of us here on Kenzie Jones. Substitution for Christian Brothers. Rachel Lee checks in for Lauren Taylor. And De'Asia Marsh comes in for Jordan Jones. Enochs swings it to Jones here. Sets a screen.
Right to Bryn Little, guarded heavily by Cheyenne Cunningham here. Nice
good
pass
look
from
right
Eames.
There.
And that's something that they've done a couple times today.
They found something in the Falcons defense a little bit to get some more points on the board.
Cunningham driving inside and is fouled on her way to the basket. So she'll go to the line for two shots. The foul is on Bryn Little.
Cheyenne Cunningham might be the fastest player on this team, honestly. Moving up and down the court. Even with the ball, Cheyenne Cunningham just finds a way to weave in and out of the defenses all the time.
First one is good from Cunningham.
Defense, let's go!
She's a 77% free throw shooter on the season. And the second is good as well. Back to an 18-point lead from Montevallo here. 1:40 left to go before half. Falcons putting a little pressure on the Buccaneers as they bring the ball forward here. But Kenzie Jones able to dribble right past it and take it to the hoop. She's a big part of this Christian Brothers offense, averaging 13.9 points a game. Jennifer Andrew, wild
shot.
It's
another
fourth
shot right there on the offensive side of the ball. Haven't seen much of Paige Ward after her hot start on offense either.
Yeah, she's sat on the bench for quite some time here.
Most of the second quarter, really.
Yeah, hitting those big three-pointers. Christian Brothers shooting just 37% from the floor in today's game. The Falcons are shooting 55% from the floor. Inside to Andrew, nice move.
There it is.
And one for Jennifer Andrew.
That looked good.
And how about the pass from Cheyenne
Black? That's a great look down low.
Good confidence booster for her, too. I don't know if she's been in much this season, so.
And it's got to be a huge positive for Coach Manata when you can put in multiple bigs and they continue to play like
Bryce
and Smith do when they're out there together.
This five right now is not even really close to the starting five that we saw at the beginning of the game. So to be able to see the offense, even though the last few possessions have been forced, still put up points throughout the game is really solid.
Inside, Jennifer Andrew kicks back out to Marsh. Marsh going inside
now. Good
move
there. Great move.
And how about the patience of Jennifer Andrew? She realized she was being trapped and kicked the ball out instead of trying to force something up.
And that helps create space, too, because when you pass that ball up top and you move outside, it draws your defender away with you, which helps create the open lane.
Little will try a three. Knocks it down with 10 seconds to go in the half. Nautica Philpott, 6 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1.
Great
and
shot right there.
Gets it to go before the buzzer expires. Coach Fanata wanted a foul call there also, but Philpott able to take it coast to coast as we go to halftime with the Falcons leading 55-35.
Either way, good way going into the half.
What an offensive performance.
That's the best half we've seen offensively from the Falcons, I think, all season long. Maybe within
within
the past couple years, to be quite honest with you.
I mean, just an incredible performance. The Falcons shot 59% from the floor in that first half. They shot 62% from the three-point line and 85% from the free throw line. So
you can't ask for much more. Can't ask for much more, and especially on the defensive side of the ball too. Christian Brothers did not make many shots. That comes from the Falcons not allowing their short perimeter shooters to get good shots off as well.
All right. Well, we will take a break here for the moment, but we are going to have some interviews with our women's lacrosse coach and a player for the women's lacrosse team. Spring sports starting up here for Montevallo this season. Women's lacrosse, men's lacrosse, baseball, softball,
track and field, golf,
track and field, and tennis, or everything.
Tennis, a lot of sports.
Over the next couple weeks, we're going to be previewing our spring sports. Today, we're going to be talking to Coach Frank Rogers of the women's lacrosse team during the halftime of this game. And during the men's game, we'll talk to Coach Jason Lang of the men's lacrosse team. So we're going to take a short break and we'll be back with a conversation with Coach Frank Rogers. Stay with us here on Montevallo for You.
All right, turn the play-by-play back on.
When is it what?
Oh.
won't be able to hear us in there. So the camera guy, camera woman is going to have to, okay? Hey, so that mic is hot. You get over there, that mic's hot, okay?
Hey, you just let me know when. Alright. All right, hello and welcome back into Trustmark Arena. I'm Wyatt Hall and I'm joined by Coach Frank Rogers, the head women's lacrosse coach here at Montevallo. And Coach, fourth year of the program, you're in your fourth year as the head coach. What are your expectations or how do you kind of approach this season as a fourth year of the program?
Well, we keep growing and getting better every year. And with the addition of each class, it's getting stronger and stronger. So our goal every year is to get better on our records and everything. So, you know, we keep bringing in good, strong teams, and we keep growing. Plus, this is our first senior class, so we're expecting to go out with a strong showing with them.
Yeah, Coach, you bring in 9 freshmen to this year's team. Just talk about the newcomers you have coming in this year.
Yeah, we brought in 9 freshmen, then we brought in 3 mid-years also. So they've been filling in and fitting in really well. Across the board, they've been a strong access to us, so it's hard to even single out one of them. They've all fit in well, and you know, with our sport being a team sport, we need the numbers. We can't play 10 or 12 people. We have to, you know, we have to be a strong 30, and that's what they have been so far in practice.
And Coach, you mentioned the seniors. You have 7 seniors this year. They've been with the program for all 4 years. Just talk about the first senior class in this program and what they mean to the team this season.
Well, I mean, they mean everything. Yeah. They started the program. They're the foundation. They've laid the standards and everything, and they keep growing. They keep every year. They've been the ones that have been there for the new classes and to help them. And you know, they're the ones setting the standards. And they know how much they mean to the program, and they've been a great asset to it.
And one of those, specifically Jamie Hudak, returns having scored 60 goals last year. She's a leading returning scorer. Just talk about how important she is specifically to the team this season.
Jamie each year has been strong for us as a finisher. She plays a very important position for us in a low attack, and she's got to be a strong finisher. But she's been not just as a goal scorer. She's been a strong asset in bringing our whole attack together, which helps a lot. She's been a strong leader and communicator and everything, and it's one of the reasons we're looking for that success that we're going to have this year.
All right. And, Coach, is there anything you'd like to add?
No, I think the senior class is the big strong point for us. And not just Jamie, Rafina Ahmed in goal, who's been an all-conference player. Georgie Griffin, who was all-conference and all-academic last year for us, has been a strong asset to us. And, you know, we just keep growing and getting better, and we're excited for the year.
All right. Well, Coach, thank you for joining us here, and good luck to the season.
Thank you.
Georgie's over here. Yeah, we're going to get a chance to talk to Georgie Griffin as well, one of the seniors on this team. Georgie, thank you for joining us here. And fourth year, you're the first senior class. So, first of all, how does that feel?
Well, first off, it's an honor. It's a little nerve-wracking, honestly, because we're done after this. But it is an honor, and it's good to be out there, and it's sad, honestly. But, yeah.
What is your biggest expectations or goals for your team or for yourself going into this season?
For the team, we really just want to make it to that championship final game. We've made it to the championship tournament every year, but we've never made it to that final game, and I think that's a really big goal for us. Also, really just trying to compete with Young Harris. They've one every year. So I think those are big goals for us, and for me, just to play the best season I've had.
Yeah. And talk about the freshmen and the newcomers you have joining you this season.
Yeah, our freshmen, they're learning really fast. Our transfers are great. I think we have a solid squad this year, and I think we're really going to be able to compete. So hopefully we can get it done and accomplish what we need to.
All right. Well, Georgie, thank you for joining us here, and good luck to the season.
Thank you.
And thank you all for joining us here as we get a preview to women's lacrosse for this 2019 season. We'll be back for the second half of action between the Montevallo Falcons and the Christian Brothers Buccaneers.
Check.
Coach, talk about specifically the men's team. What are some goals and expectations you have for them?
Well, the main goal that we want to do is, and I've talked with the team about this, is one of their big goals is to make the regional tournament. So now, if they make it or not, that's not an indicator of success or failure, but the main thing is that we have something to strive for, and you know these guys are very hungry, so I'm really excited again this year.
And talk about some of the newcomers you have coming into the program this season for the men's side.
For the men's side, we have freshman Dylan Valentine from Canada, so a lot of talent there. And Tobias Rausch, he's from Germany. So they're going to be right there in the lineup, too. So they're going to be competing for that, a lot of starting time. So, again, it's we're all looking to push each other to get better And so that's the whole focus of our program, is to make each other better at the end of the day. So I'm really excited with these two freshmen coming in too. So.
And with the women's side, what are some specific goals and expectations you have for them?
And we have four seniors this year, so they want to go out, you know, as the best they've been here. So best, you know, results-wise they've been here so far. So one of the big goals that we're trying to do is make sure that they leave, you know, this program, you know, better than they found. And I know they've already done that. So, you know, high expectations of the ladies too.
And who are some of the big newcomers you have coming in for the women's side?
For the women's side, we have two freshmen this year. We have Whitney Hamilton from Louisiana, very strong student and athlete, and she played very well here in the fall. And then also a freshman, Anne Christine Liu from Switzerland, and she had a very strong showing at regional tournament down in Lakeland, and she played very strong throughout the whole fall season. So, you know, they're a great addition too. I can't wait to get the season started.
All right, well, Coach, thank you for joining us, and good luck to the season.
Thank you, appreciate it.
Yes, sir. And now we're going to get to talk to a player from the men's and women's side joining me quickly here before we get started in the second half. I'm joined by Emily Beatty and Jorg Trompler. You're in your second season, Jorg, correct?
Yes.
Talk about some of your expectations going into this season.
I think that we will have a good team this semester, and I think we will be on top of the conference. So I think we'll do well this semester.
And Emily, you're going into your senior year. Talk about your expectations and goals you have for your senior season.
Well, we had a really good season last year. We got nationally ranked for the first time. We made it to the semifinals of conference. We've been working really hard in our preseason. We've been doing a lot of conditioning, focusing on doubles. So I'm really excited to get the season started, and hopefully we'll make it one better than last year.
And Jorg, talk about some of the new teammates you have coming into this team and what they can bring to the team this season.
So we got two new teammates, and they will bring a lot of effort even in practice, and I think they will add our team very well. So they're good players, and they're also excited to get into the team and get action to play. So we're all pretty excited to play.
And Emily, talk about some of the incoming freshmen and newcomers to the women's side this year.
Yeah, we have two great girls. One's from Switzerland and the other's American, and they've put a lot of hard work in, both doubles and singles, and I'm really excited. We also have a combination of four seniors with the experience, so I think working together will be a really good combination.
All right. Well, thank you all for joining us, and good luck to the season.
Thank you.
And that'll do it for the halftime report here between the Montevallo Falcons and the Christian Brothers Buccaneers as we get to preview the men's and women's tennis for this coming season. We'll be back for the game. Stay with us here on Montevallo for You.
I would prefer to go ahead and at least have.
And welcome back in the Trustmark Arena. Montevallo and Christian Brothers facing off for the second half of play, a 20-point lead. Guys, what do you do if you're the Christian Brothers side here to cut into this lead?
Well, I can see that, like we were talking about after the first quarter, they're back in that zone. I think that that's going to be really helpful for them, as it just was in this play. They only have seven players. They're not very tall. A very tall team, rather. I think that just playing a very safe defense is going to have to cut it and help to cut into it.
If you're Christian Brothers, you can't force the issue like you did on that pass right there. And they almost turned it over down here after they got the defensive rebound as well. I understand that you're down 20 points, but you're just going to have to start taking contested shots because you don't have enough time to start passing the ball four or five times every single offensive possession.
It's going to have to be a gradual comeback for them. I don't think there will be a lot of, like,
The way that the Falcons are playing on offense, Christian Brothers is not going to be able to go on a 20-0 run.
I don't think so.
And Nautica Philpott drains a three-pointer, and that's the first of the game for her, and what a way to get started here in the second half.
Good deflection on her part right there.
And you love to see a player that, you know, everyone's going to struggle every now and then, but will right. still continue to
exactly.
shoot and find her rhythm there on that shot.
When Philpott now 10 points on the game, that's put her over yep. 200, that's put her over 200 points on the season as well. So she's having a very good year offensively for the Falcons.
And Kayla Enoch's inside. Nice pass from Kinsey Jones.
Both of these teams have a lot of their points coming from inside the paint. Christian Brothers had 16 of their 37 now coming from inside the paint, and the Falcons have 34 of their 58 coming from inside the paint as well.
Yeah, the Falcons have been known to crash the paint all season long. Annika Philpott comes up with it here, tries
dangerous
the smooth
pass,
but taken away easily by Kinsey Jones, and that frustrates Coach Manata. Enoch's on the elbow, guarded by Rice here. Over to Jones. Jones inside, coming off the screen from Enoch's, is fouled by Aaliyah Rice going to the hoop.
That's one thing that you like to see out of Coach Vanata, though, because despite you're up by 21 points, and that's awesome, but he still expects you to do things the right way.
Right.
You can't afford to have sloppy passes because he knows that if you get into a situation where it is close late in the game, you can't fall into what you have done when you had the big lead as well when it comes to sloppy passes, bad shots, and unsmart fouls like we just saw.
You got to play consistent no matter what the score
exactly.
is. Jones misses the first free throw. And the second one bounces out. Ward comes up with the rebound.
Falcons now back to pretty much what their starting lineup was at the beginning of the game as well.
Inside, Aaliyah Rice going baseline. Tries a reverse layup. Can't get it to go.
We've seen so many reverse layups today.
Again with the reverse layups. I don't know why they really are into trying it today, but it hasn't worked too well, so.
A jumper from Lee, no good. Falcons out and running again. Philpott.
Good move.
Passes outside to Rice.
Still with that big smile on her face, too.
Yeah, for a second I thought she was going to heave that one up. Philpott will take it, though. Can't get that one to go. But Rice comes crashing in, trying to get the rebound, but lands into the hands of Kinsey Jones instead. Smith gets the rebound.
Not a lot of offense from either team, really, to start this second half.
I would like Ward to shoot that.
I would have, too. She's had the hot hand all game long from behind the arc.
Inside, Smith working against the smaller Lee here.
There
layup
it is.
High
there
off the
is.
Glass and good. And Nautica Philpott comes
play.
Back with the steal. And
what
her jumper off the glass, good. Nautica Philpott loves that.
That's exactly
the steal than the bank
the
jumper.
Good quick 2 points right there for them.
That's smart basketball, too.
For sure.
Very smart
oh, yeah.
basketball.
The Falcons continue an impressive offensive performance, 62-37. Jones' high dribble loses it out of bounds. And everything going wrong for the Buccaneers.
Yeah, everything. They still they had the long halftime, and they still can't figure out what they need to do against this Falcons defense.
Jump shot from Philpott, no good. Enoch gets the rebound.
We kind of hit it on in the first half. This Falcons team, this women's Falcons team, is doing things that we really haven't seen in years. And that kind of goes to credit Coach Van Adden, what he's done with this team, getting his players in here, having them buy into his system, and listening to him and playing together as a team, hence why they have 62 points still with over 5 minutes to go in the third quarter.
Yeah, and this is Coach Van Adden's third season. He's had a chance to bring in several different recruiting classes here now and kind of establish what he wants to do, and this is the first season we're really seeing it all come together.
He has over 500 career wins for a reason.
Yeah. And he's approaching 200 at Montevallo, has 186 I believe all time at Montevallo, as Aaliyah Rice knocks down the layup on a brilliant spin move. Lee will try a three. No good. Rice comes up with the board. And just miscommunication there. Philpott was calling for the ball, but Sane just threw it right off her knee.
Just a bad mistake.
That right there again, Coach Van Adden holding the ball just to talk to his players. Again, still expecting the smart plays out of his players.
Sure.
I mean, you're up big, but you still got to – you can't just make plays like
and
that.
And there's no pressure. I mean, there's no reason to pass that ball off in that situation,
but
and that's something that's his
especially
team
when neither person's looking either.
Right. I think they kind of knew it too. They kind of looked at each other like, oh, all right.
in the corner. Sarah Owen wide open for a three-pointer. No good. But Little comes up with the rebound, knocked it right out of the hands of Courtney Smith.
That shows right there, Christian Brothers grabbed that rebound, and the first thing they did was run back out to the top of the key because it shows that they don't know what they need to do offensively inside because they haven't been able to figure it out all game.
Little a three-pointer again off the back iron. Flat comes up with the board this time. And quick outlet pass ahead to Deasia Marsh. She gets stripped by Lee out of bounds off of Christian Brothers' Romaine Matavala basketball. And I don't think Marsh saw her, but she had Courtney Smith trailing.
She did.
Would have been a nice pass. But with a dead ball, media timeout here. 4:44 left to go in the third. Falcons still leading Christian Brothers here 64-37.
Christian Brothers still hasn't been able to find anything offensively. No. Since the beginning of the game, they haven't had anything. And I mean, even this to start the second half, they've only had 2 points in almost 6 minutes of play throughout the quarter. And the Falcons have put up 9 themselves. So both sides, not really a whole lot of offense, but the Falcons still figuring out a way to do more than what Christian Brothers can.
So we'll step away here for a moment. Coach Fanata in that timeout preaching to his team to still protect the ball, and that has got to be a point of emphasis. I mean, this is a team that averages 18 turnovers a game. Mm-hmm. And this team is, I mean, you have the lead 64-37, but you still have 14 minutes of play left in the game.
Exactly.
He's a big fundamentals guy, even, you know, with being up as high as we are. It's like we can still, you know, improve on just – and simple things need to still be a big part of the game, as we were talking about, so –
Flack is fouled, so it's she's
kinda,
at the line to shoot two.
It's
kind
of similar to Coach Young of the men's team.
Yeah.
They might have different philosophies, but they're very similar. And hey, make sure you do things the right way.
Right.
You can as long as you figure out a way to get it done, just do it the right way because they know in the long run it'll work out either way as
For
well.
Sure.
Little comes up with the rebound as Flack misses the second, and with the Falcons winning the turnover battle today, have only turned over the ball 8 times while they have forced 10 turnovers for Christian Brothers. And a foul away from the ball. Paige Ward got tangled up with Lauren Taylor inside, so they're going to give Ward the foul. Jordan Jones is going to come in for Ward here. Coach Renata giving Ward some encouragement after picking up that foul. Little swings it to McKenzie Lane. Lane inside to Taylor. Sloppy pass, but Taylor comes up with it. In the corner to Lee, tries a three. No good. Marsh comes up with the rebound. And Marsh has played well off the bench today for the Falcons. Jones on the wing, trying to find Flack inside. Taken away by Lauren Taylor. And deflected by Jones out of bounds will remain Christian Brothers ball. Substitution here. Kenzie Jones comes back in. And if Christian Brothers wants to have any chance going forward in this game, Kenzie Jones has to be on the floor.
Has to be. Mm-hmm. It's their leading scorer throughout the whole season. So it's just they just have to find something to do on offense. And like we said earlier in the quarter, they're going to have to start taking all the contested shots they can because they're running out of time.
Savannah Lee with it, gives to Jordan Jones, trying to find Flack inside, but she can't find position. And a lot of miscommunication going on offense here for the Falcons, and it turns into 2 points on the other end from Bren Little.
Bren Little.
And we see Nautica Philpott getting ready to check in here, maybe kind of calm down things.
That's exactly what I was thinking. She's been the one that's been able to calm things down the whole game long, and she's been the one that's really been able to facilitate the ball inside as well from the top of the key.
For sure.
Jones driving baseline.
Great move.
Nice layup from Jordan Jones.
Jones!
67-39. Jones driving inside. Bounce pass to Lane. Swings it to Lee. Lauren Taylor kick out. Bryn Little for three. No good. Flack comes up with the board. And the Falcons seeming to be a little too aggressive here. Now getting too comfortable with the lead, 67-39. But in the last couple of possessions, except for that layup Jordan Jones made, they have not executed well.
No.
Nautica Philpott comes back in. Nice pass inside to Kenzie Jones, who backs down Philpott and gets the layup off the assist from McKenzie Lane.
You can kind of tell the Falcons are like definitely not looking to foul when they get the ball inside. They're, once the ball is inside, they're playing very timid defense, but that's probably a good move being as up as high as they are right now just to not get into foul trouble.
Battle for the ball comes up to Rachel Lee. She calls a timeout. So a timeout here for Christian Brothers as Montevallo leads 67-41 at 1:44 left to go in the third. And we'll be back here in Trustmark Arena.
Minus one. There's everybody in the plus. Is Cheyenne still minus one or is everybody in the plus? Yeah.
Back after the timeout. 1:44 left to go in the game. 13 total points for Nautica Philpott. She leads all scorers here. And she's back in the game.
Those have been a quiet 13 points as well because it's not like you see her going up with shots every single possession.
Yeah, we've seen a balanced offensive attack involving Ward, Philpott,
and there's a steal.
Rice. Jordan Jones goes coast to coast after the steal. And that's what you want to see from your bench players.
For exactly. I was going to say the Falcons have done a great job about involving everybody into the game today.
And that was good for Jordan Jones specifically because she hasn't played too well
right
in the minutes we've seen her play today, but comes up with a big bucket there.
But yeah, everybody that's coming off the bench is bringing really good energy onto the floor. So
Philpott ahead to Lee, went off her foot, back into the hands of Cheyenne Flack, who knocks it down from free throw line.
That ball bounced off of Lee's foot. It was a little low on the pass, but it still is an unbelievable look to even fit the ball through that hole.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Taylor on the perimeter, guarded by Lee here, gives it to Enix on the elbow, to McKenzie Lane, 8 on the shot clock now, Lane, errant pass, Jordan
steal.
Jones comes up with
Look
the
up.
Steal again, ahead to Nautica Philpott, who patiently takes the layup,
73-41, and Philpott was trying to draw a little bit of contact there as well. Shot clock turned off here as we wind down in the third quarter. Kenzie Jones brings it across half court, 8 seconds to go. We'll hold for the final shot. Jones, 2 seconds.
Might not even get it off.
Is not even going to get the shot off. De'Asia Marsh comes up with the steal instead, and that ends the third quarter. Matahala winning 73-41, and we still have a quarter to go.
This is, that's great defense right there by the Falcons, not even let them get it off. And this has just been the best complete game that we've seen from the Falcons in a really long time.
Yeah, the highest point total the Falcons have scored all season long is 87, and they scored that in an overtime game against Spring Hill College.
They're going to get close to that right there. And if they continue to score the way they have been, I would assume that they would break that so far.
All right, well, we'll step away for a moment here on Matavala for you.
Wow. This is good. Yeah. This is good. It's
awful.
And the same five that were on the floor return to start the fourth quarter for the Falcons. Christian Brothers gets the ball first here, down 73-41.
One of the big things we heard Coach Van Adda talking about in the huddle right there was, forget about the score, we still have one more quarter to play, which again shows how he still wants smart, fundamental, good shots basketball throughout the rest of the game.
Nautica Philpott out quickly ahead
to
Jordan
pass.
Jones. What a pass.
What a pass.
What a pass. Philpott really fooled good. Me on that one. I thought she was going to the right side. But what a pass from Nautica Philpott. That's six assists now for Philpott.
Christian Brothers got it inside. Good look from them.
Yeah, Lauren Taylor with the bucket there, and we see the full court pressure on again, but a cross-court pass to Savannah Lee, and Nautica Philpott gets her seventh assist.
That was a good-looking pass.
You have to wonder how Savannah Lee found her way behind that defense right there.
I just think they didn't really anticipate a pass like that because it's so rare. But
and a nice pass there. I thought Bryn Little was going to take the baseline layup, but passes out instead. Kenzie Jones goes in and is fouled. Nautica Philpott commits the foul. So 15 points for Philpott, 7 assists, and she is plus 31.
That's
in today's
unbelievable
game.
Wow. Stat. Holy cow.
Hey! 77-45. Christian Brothers applies some pressure here as Philpott brings it forward. They don't go back to the full court press. But
I don't know if I've ever seen anybody that's plus 30 in any game that I can remember of, honestly.
Yeah.
It is certainly impressive. Marsh kick out to Philpott. Philpott will take it almost from the logo. Bounces around. Jordan Jones comes up with the offensive board and turns it into two. Jordan Jones.
Sometimes that happens where a shot attempt that may not be the best attempt ever will just turn into an offensive rebound and a point made. So looks like
Kenzie Jones inside and is fouled. Makes a shot as well. De'Asia Marsh, I believe, committed the foul there.
Falcons have 4 subs coming in. Looks like they're changing up the entire roster. But
they're going to say the foul was actually before the basket, so 2 shots for Kenzie Jones here as a host of Falcons come in.
Everyone but Jordan Jones coming out.
Jennifer Andrew checks in, so does Rachel Baker, Tierra McLeod. and Alyssa Williams. And Coach Fanata takes a timeout, a full timeout here with 8 minutes to go in the fourth. Falcons leading 79-48. And we have just seen an absolute show from the Falcons in today's game.
Mm. Well, that's why you see some of these players that just checked in, and some of the freshmen are people that average, you know, around 8 minutes a game, trying to get them some more experience with a big lead like this.
Yeah.
But still, Rachel Baker's the one that checked in. She came up huge in the second game of the season against Tuskegee. So even though she's still not gotten a lot of minutes, these are still players that have experience in big-time games that can still come out here and provide for you on the floor.
Yeah, we'll probably see the Falcons have a little fun here with the new freshman.
I would assume that that's why Coach Van had to call a timeout, was to try and figure out what he wants to do with this new rotation.
I mean, the game is still going on. You still got to coach. You still got to play. It's 79-48, but there's still 8 minutes.
Exactly.
And on the Christian Brothers side, if you're Coach Condra, how do you keep your team checked into this game?
I think just tell them to play hard and just, you know, this is a tough loss on the road, and unfortunately that's part of the game. But I don't know. I think that there's a lot that Christian Brothers might be able to get out of this game, and a lot of them, you know, later in the season, you know, this might be a good film game. Be like, okay, here's where we went wrong and other examples. Yeah. So.
Well, especially these two teams still play one more time at Christian Brothers late in the season, which could end up being a huge conference game either way. So this is where you still try to figure out what you want to do as a team.
Yeah.
This is where you find out which players on your team still play hard, whether you're down a lot or up a lot or anything like this.
Yeah, stat line for Nautica Philpott, 15 points, 5 rebounds, 7 assists, and 31 in the plus minus.
That's crazy. That's a great game.
Jennifer Andrew on the wing is fouled quickly by Rachel Lee.
First foul number 4, Rachel Lee, her first personal team foul, number 1.
And we haven't seen much of Tierra McLeod this season, but she comes in and she was an outstanding high school player.
Hartsville
Carroll High School. And her layup won't go.
I just want to point out right now that every player for the Falcons right now is a freshman. It's completely freshman lineup out there right there. So all the young ones getting some experience. It's good to see.
It's what you like to see.
Yeah, for sure.
Alyssa Williams commits the foul there. A freshman out of Eagan, Louisiana. She was actually a big-time volleyball player in high school as well as playing basketball.
It also just shows the depth of this recruiting class. I mean, a lot of freshmen coming in. But
Coach Van Adda is not one that's afraid to go out of his area of recruiting as
for
well.
Sure.
He'll go anywhere to find the players that he thinks will fit this team.
But there's a lot of players from Alabama on this roster. As Rachel Baker tries a three, it won't go.
That just goes to the credit of his coaching, though, too, finding the right players for your system and making them buy in.
Oh, for sure.
Lee's three-pointer is good, and we look at a geographic breakdown. Alyssa Williams, the only player from Louisiana, and then three players from Tennessee, everyone else from Alabama.
Mm-hmm. That can almost be going against the norm in a lot of times, though, is getting an all-in-state roster. A lot of coaches are a little bit, you know, wanting to branch out and recruit from all over the country. So,
but then again, I mean, Alabama is nationally not necessarily known as a basketball state, but if you look at some of the games, if you're from the state, they have a lot of good high school basketball teams throughout the state as well.
For sure.
Tierra McLeod inside. Draws the contact as well, so she'll go to the line to try and get the and-one.
And-one. Personal foul, number 30, Lauren Taylor. Fourth personal team foul, number 3.
And McLeod converts the and-one. 82-51.
Falcons now just 5 points away from that season high of 87.
Enoch's a long two, no good. McLeod comes up with the board. Jennifer Jones, outlet pass
good
to
look.
Jennifer Andrew. Layup is good, and the contact. Jennifer Andrew, everything going right for the Falcons here. An and one opportunity.
First foul,
84-51, and
What an outlet pass that was from Jordan Jones.
That was Nautica Philpott tight, like right there to find. And I mean, Jennifer right here to even catch that ball with one hand going up high and getting him, and then bringing it back down to go up for the and one opportunity.
Can't convert the and one. It bounces off of Alyssa Williams' foot. So with all the freshmen in, some things going right for Montevallo, or continuing to go right,
continuing,
I should say.
You're definitely continuing.
Lane tries a three-pointer.
In and
that
out.
That one rolls out.
Off the mark.
Jordan Jones again in transition to Rachel Baker. Baker in the low post. That's unusual. Kicks out to Williams. Andrew driving inside. Can't get it to go.
Good
Williams
rebound.
Gets the rebound. And I believe we're going to have a foul before the shot.
See some support from the bench, so too. The upperclassmen
really
excited
the
for
the
freshmen, yeah.
If that last three that went in and out doesn't explain Christian Brothers Day the way that it did, then I don't really know what does.
And Andrew knocks down the first. Andrew hails from Hoover High School.
Pretty local talent then.
Yeah, Jordan Jones actually from Helena High School, not far down the road.
Yeah.
Jeff Andrew from Hoover, so some local products.
It's interesting when you have all big in-state rosters, because a lot of the teams or a lot of your players, you play against each other in high school.
Exactly.
And then, you know.
Lauren Taylor, her three-pointer won't go. Little gets the rebound. And this is the future of this Montevallo team.
Yeah.
No singers on this roster. Only two upperclassmen. That's Aaliyah Rice and Paige Ward, but these are the freshmen. This is the future of Coach Gary Venata's squad.
To be quite honest with you, it looks good, too.
Yeah, it does
it
look
looks
good
on the court.
That goes out of bounds off Rachel Lee. Jordan Jones inside off the
great
glass.
Look.
And what a screen from Alyssa Williams allowing that lane to open up.
The Falcons have just done such a good job about finding ways to get the ball inside the paint today.
And Andrew draws the charge on the other end. Making plays on the defensive end and the offensive end.
This freshman rotation is playing fantastic basketball.
And McLeod airballs that jumper there. 4:59. Lane inside, floater off the mark. Baker gets the rebound.
You would think that this Christian Brothers team just has to be completely fatigued out with only bringing seven players to this game.
Sure. I mean, and the Falcons have played a lot more than seven. They have a full bench,
everybody.
A lot of depth, and they're out and running in transition as well.
When you're able to bring in five freshmen
right.
in one rotation, it shows that the depth that you have on your team.
For sure.
Sarah Owen checks in. McLeod inside, no good. Taylor the rebound. Taylor a three-pointer, knocks it down, top of the key, 88-54.
I'm sure the Falcons, unless it's sloppy defense, they don't mind giving those up at all anymore.
No.
And we mentioned 87 was the highest point total. They passed that with 88. And starting to play a little sloppy on the offensive end, a turnover.
Ooh.
And a foul by Andrew. Could have been a jump ball, possibly.
Yeah.
Cheyenne Cunningham checks in now. Little thought about a three. We'll send it to Mackenzie Lane, who knocks it down.
That was a well-set up play from the start.
And Christian Brothers still not going away
not
here.
Going away.
88-57.
Still playing hard.
I definitely commend their efforts coming in with seven players and playing hard the whole game. So,
Andrew inside, wild layup, no good. McLeod comes up with a rebound, and the jump ball is called. It'll go in favor of Christian Brothers.
Come on out. No more threes now. Come on, White, no three.
And Little just throws it away into the Christian Brothers bench. Sloppy play on the offensive end. And what do you want to see from the group on the floor for Montevallo as we play this last 3 minutes?
I think you want to see good synergy and team chemistry for sure. And then you also want to see just being able to play together. I think that's important. It's not necessarily – I'm not looking for them to make every shot. I'm not looking for them – I'm looking – you know, I understand that they're going to make mistakes as younger players, but the chemistry needs to start building now and, you know – I'm looking ahead, so.
Building the foundation.
For sure. That was an interesting free throw form from her. Yeah.
Andrew knocks that one down. Lane in transition. That one won't go. Little comes up with it. And she is fouled, they say. Jennifer Andrew commits the foul.
Right through the two girls, she walks. She broke both feet. Number 22, Bray.
And I mentioned earlier, Tara McLeod was an outstanding high school player for Carroll High School. Throughout her career, she averaged a double-double, 17 points per game and 16 rebounds.
That's fantastic.
Where'd she play for?
Carroll High School.
Mm. Look at Cheyenne Cunningham in here. Some really good moves to get inside the paint right
by
there.
Andrews there to get the ball back.
They wanted Cunningham to shoot that. Now Alyssa Williams will take it in the post. Turn around. It is good.
Look at this bench over here going crazy for the freshman.
Excited for the future for the program.
91-59. What a display these girls have put on tonight.
Unbelievable. Absolutely unbelievable.
Baker comes up with the steal.
And a good pass, too.
Andrews now looking up the floor.
Good move.
She'll keep it.
Yeah, just a wild layup there. But. Sarah Owen driving inside, moving past Cunningham. No good. Cunningham will get the rebound. Baker will fire the three. Fire. No good. We know how good of a three-point shooter she can be. Andrew comes up with the rebound.
Gets it herself.
Yeah, gets it deflected, gets it back, and puts it in for two. And really, the Falcons cannot do much wrong.
No, not at all.
Not at this point.
93-59. Will they get the triple digits?
They're gonna have to make threes if they want to do that.
I definitely thought in the first quarter they were going to be up over 100, but.
Yeah, halftime had 55 points.
Yeah.
And knowing Coach Finn's attitude, I don't think he's going to want to really push it once the shot clock ends up going off. So they're just going to run the clock down, I would assume.
With 1:10 left to go, I'm sure we won't see much offensively.
I mean, shoot, that would be really cool to see, but I don't think it'll happen.
Baker will try three, and she knocks it down in the corner, 96-59.
She has a lot of confidence as a freshman coming in here, too.
She does.
And she had a three-pointer to send the Spring Hill game to overtime freshman in her first game. It's a rebound there. 15 seconds between the shot clock and game clock, and the Falcons are going here.
The rest of the crowd wants him to get to 100 as well.
Cunningham was certainly trying, but goes out of bounds off herself. So it'll be Christian Brothers ball. And we hear Coach Vanatta say no shots when they get the ball back. So
it's exactly when that shot clock goes off. Just run it down.
And Baker gets the ball. Shot clock turned off. So they're just going to dribble out the clock here. And that's
what we expected. 96 points for the Falcons, though.
This is, within probably the last 5 years, the best game the Falcons have played. Mm.
96-59. Cunningham stands at midcourt and holds the ball. And
you can't ask for anything better.
You got to commend the effort of Christian Brothers. They come in, just seven players, and they played as well as they could.
Yeah.
96-59, and eventually the depth gets the best of you.
And the Falcons did good because we talked about the height disadvantage for Christian Brothers. The Falcons did a very good job about not letting Christian Brothers get really good shots off the perimeter and staying with them in transition basketball throughout the whole game.
And the thing that I liked is everyone got involved today. I mean, I think everybody scored for this Model Valley team.
They might have.
I have to look at the final box, but I believe everybody scored. And that's – you can't help but smile about
it's
that.
It, and it's a big conference win, too, because it puts you to 9-6 on the season, 5-2 in the conference, and now you're just one game behind of being third place in the conference overall.
All right. Well, we will get a chance to talk to Coach Gary Vanana in just a second. Maybe we'll get to talk to Nautica Philpott as well. But stay with us here on Montevallo for you as we'll get some interviews.
I mean, I can try and you can talk to both if you want. I can try and grab her. Either way,
we'll fine. We'll do one at a time. Well, eventually I'm not going to be here. So yeah. If you want to talk to Nautica, I'll talk to Gary.
Okay. We have a final test sheet yet?
I'm coming. Ray's coming.
Okay.
We'll do them one at a time.
Yeah. Just want me to sit down first then?
We'll do Nautica first.
Yeah.
Do you want to do that?
Yeah. Are they bringing the camera over here?
No.
Okay.
You good?
Back here with Nautica Philpott after a huge win for the Montevallo Falcons with a 96-59 win. Nautica, what were the biggest keys in that game for y'all just to really control the game from the start?
Coach just wanted us to set the tempo and just push the ball and run our offense as we do in practice and just play defense. And, you know, as best as we can. So, you know, that's what we came out and did.
So you in this game came out with 15 points, 7 assists. What was it that just worked for you offensively throughout the entire game?
My teammates, they spread the floor for me, for themselves as well, for me to get them the ball. And it just worked out for the both of us to set the tempo for the game. And that's what we...
Christian Brothers came into this game averaging about 63 points on the year. A very good team shooting the ball from the perimeter. In this game, you guys only held them to 59 points, and you played very good perimeter defense. What was it that you guys did to not necessarily let them shoot very well from outside?
Coach wanted us to pressure them very hard. He told us that, you know, they're a good three-point shooting team and that we were going to have to pressure them as well. That's what we did. We tried not to let them get as many threes. I mean, you know, they're a good shooting team, so... I mean, we tried to not let them get as many threes as they usually been getting. So.
And then last question real quick. We saw a lot of the freshmen come in late in the game once the lead really extended. How cool was it to see some of the underclassmen come in and really play well, just as good as you guys did as well?
Yes, I mean, it's very good seeing them playing well for them to be young. But they still have a lot of growing to do. So, you know, we still have to work. They still have to work in practice and, you know, get better like everybody else in practice.
Right. Hey, appreciate you. Good Thanks. Game. We'll talk to you later on.
Thank you.
All right, we'll be right back with an interview with Coach Van Adam.
Yeah.
for them all. Them was the goals. Never care about my soul. Take them way till I get old. I'm on these hold up. Wait a minute, new beginnings. I was down and I'm winning. I know who did it and I don't forget it. You know I'm still about the family business. I gotta get back.
We're back here in Trustmark Arena. I'm joined now by Coach Gary Van Atta. Coach, very dominant win there. The offense was probably one of the best offensive performances I've seen since I've been here. 96 points.
Well, I'll tell you what, our you know, we're a very young team, and we know how talented they are, but you're going to get this type of, you know, up and down type of thing. Well, one night we'll score 47 like we did a shorter, and then here we get this. But, you know, Christian Brothers is a really good team. I mean, you saw what they just did to West Al.
Yep.
And, you know, so you just – you never know. But playing on the road in this league is tough no matter what. And we know that just like everybody else. It's important for us to try our best to defend our home court, and that's what we're trying to do, trying our best to do. And but I thought our kids came out and focused on the game plan and what we tried to do. And, you know, I was just really proud from start to finish about their ability to accomplish that. And we were unselfish. I thought we passed the ball.
Yeah.
We took advantage of our strength, which was our points inside. And you know, we had 62 points in the paint tonight, which I think is indicative of the type of team that we should be. Our bench scored 47 points. That's another thing I feel like is strong about our team. So it was nice to see them put it all together, you know, one night. And hopefully this is something we can build on and continue to do it throughout the rest of the season.
And last time when we talked at the Sanford game, we talked about the assists were not what you wanted and the turnovers were more than what you'd like to see. Well, today, 16 assists and turned the ball over just 13 times.
Yeah. Well, the bad part about that is we had 39 baskets. So you'd like to see those assists up a little bit higher than that. But you know, I always like to see at least, I'd like to have 60% of our baskets should be assisted. I'd like to think so. We should have had, you know, anywhere around 20, you know, 18 to 20 assists, but that's still a good number, and I'm proud of it. And the assist, the turnovers, you know, I'm a zero guy, you know, when it comes to turnovers. But the way when we made the turnovers, the thing I was not really happy with tonight is we made the turnovers in situations where an easy pass would have been the answer. And but, you know, they're young and they got to learn that. And, you know, but I'm just really proud of them being able to put together, you know, for 40 minutes a solid performance. I thought our kids, the young kids were nervous coming off the bench at first in the first half and came back in the second half. And, you know, Jordan Jones got it going for like we saw her at the beginning of the year. It's just something that's going to happen with our team as they get more and more minutes. We hope we're going to start yelling at the right time.
Yeah, and it was the perfect time to have a game like this, 96 points, going into a tough road contest next week against Lee.
Yeah, because evidently right now, I said last time that going into West Florida, that West Florida was playing in it better than anybody in our conference at the time. And now I'm going to say Lee's playing better than everybody else in our conference at the time right now, because they're just, you know, after being beaten at home by West Florida, which was the first win West Florida Coach Yelton had ever had there.
Yep.
And then they go to Union and beat Union when they're number one in the nation. You know, says an awful lot about them. So we know they're hard to beat at home. It's a tough place to win at. You know, we're gonna enjoy this game, take a couple days off, and then get focused on Lee and try to sneak one out on the road somewhere.
All right, Coach. Well, thank you for joining us here. And, again, congratulations on the victory here tonight.
Thank you, man. I appreciate it and appreciate what you guys do, especially traveling with me when you get a time to. Thanks a lot,
yes,
man.
Sir. All right. Well, that'll do it for the women's game. Montevallo gets the victory in dominant fashion, 96-59. Stay tuned. The men will face off here in about 18 minutes. Stay with us here on Montevallo for you.
right, so we're 4-1 in our last five, games, I think. Yeah, 4-1 in our last five games. So we can hit on what do we need to do to continue like that streak, something like that. But they average basically 18 assists per game. 18 assists per game. So they're really good at moving the ball. So like before the game, we can also hit on how our defense can help stop that as well. And then if you want to find something real quick that you want to hit on beforehand, we can do that as well.
Okay, yeah. I think I just want to talk about the record, a lot of the head-to-head stuff. I might talk about Micah a little bit.
Yep.
Yeah, that's about it.
Okay, that's cool.
I want someone to, like, come to this game with a sign that says like Jack and I'm throwing out you or something.
Yeah.
Okay, so I guess whenever we start, I can say like good afternoon or whatever.
Okay.
And then for the afternoon matchup between Montebello and Christian Brothers, this is like the 12th meeting between these two teams.
Yeah.
And then right after that, you can just roll into the side foot.
Yeah, I'll take it from there. I'll start with the current record for each, and then I'll say start and line up.
Yeah. And then by that,
a little bit of their head to head.
And then by that time, we should have the tip off.
Yep.
And then we can just roll on from there.
Sounds good.
I love Scott. I wish I was an art major just for that guy.
The what?
The guy in the green jacket, yeah. He's a ceramics professor.
Yeah.
He's like so freaking chill.
Say what?
Your boys came up with
like ice. Yeah, I know it. I'm not surprised. Twelfth all time meeting.
What do we need?
Into that. Cool that. All right. Good. Ready? All right. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Trustmark Arena between this matchup between your Montevallo Falcons and the Christian Brothers Buccaneers. Falcons coming in here rolling hot, winning four of their last five. I'm Brett Batcher alongside Connor Ryan right here. Connor, what do the Falcons need to do to continue their hot winning streak?
Well, the Falcons are coming in at 7-9, the Christian Brothers 9-6. I think that they're looking to be a good team. They're coming right off. I think they really enjoy being at home, and they're a good team to have at home. I think so. University Montevallo starters are going to be Jack Yeomans, Micah Fuller, Wade Lohman, Carl Johnson, DeMarco Owens. When Christian Brothers is going to be Brad Miller, Joe Laveri, Nick DeVille, Adam DeBall, and Jacob Lyons.
And the big thing that the Falcons have to look at is Christian Brothers is coming off of a triple overtime game where Adam DeBall had a triple-double for Christian Brothers.
Right.
So that's going to be one key that the Falcons have to look at. And Christian Brothers is also very good at moving the ball around, finding ways off of off-ball screens to get the ball inside. They're averaging 17.8 assists per game. So what are the Falcons going to have to do on defense to try and find a way to stop that?
Well, as you can see from our Christian Brothers is leading us in points right now over, but we also have a higher rebound percentage from game to game. So I think that our rebounds and really just being able to clash the boards is going to be important for us and maintaining that. We definitely have the Bucks definitely have a height advantage over us with four guys over 6'7". So that's going to be a big issue today for the Falcons.
And the thing with Christian Brothers is they have a lot of people that can score. Number 34, Joshua Jackson, had 34 points against West Alabama in one of their last few games. So the Falcons are going to have to find a way somehow on defense to try and stop this high-powered offense.
Yeah. Our featured player today is Micah Fuller. Micah averaging 11 points a game and shoots about 42% from beyond the arc, which is the fifth highest percentage in the Gulf South Conference. Micah's definitely been a big leader for this team this year.
And especially coming off of an injury last year where he didn't see any playing time at all, to come in here and be a leader as a redshirt sophomore is really big for this basketball
team. Right. Micah's also a veteran of this program, 3 years with it, which in college basketball can sometimes be a lot.
Exactly. And a lot of times, too, like we see Jack Yeomans starting tonight, a lot of times at the beginning of the year, it was Jack Yeomans, the freshman, over Micah Fuller, who was a starter when he was a freshman as well. So for him to be okay with that, with Yeomans coming in and starting over him, and to now see them starting together shows how they've really worked together with continuity.
For sure.
So a big matchup here between these two teams. Christian Brothers, as Connor said, averaging 75 points a game, to Montevallo's 67. But you would assume that these two teams, they've only played 12 times. They don't know that much about each other. You would assume that this could be a very good basketball game.
I think it's going to be a great basketball game. I think the height is about the same. I think the athleticism is about the same. And neither team is – both teams have experienced a decent amount of loss this season. So
Falcons will take the tip off here as Micah Fuller will bring it down for the Falcons. Falcons like to try to move the ball around.
Definitely like to work the perimeter.
A bad pass right there from Micah Fuller and a quick turnover there for the Falcons will give Christian Brothers the ball right away. Christian Brothers already with a lot of off-ball screens moving in and out. And a good move right there for Christian Brothers to get their first 2 points of the game. And that's exactly what you said right there, the size differential between the two to make it go up and easier for the quick 2 points.
And Lohman's guarding heavily. I mean, as a forward, he's not the tallest, but he's a very long player. So hopefully he'll be able to use that to his advantage.
And the Falcons, although another turnover right there for the Falcons, although 7-9 on the season, at one point they withstood a 5-game losing streak. So to win four of their last five, to be at this point right now, to be 3-3 in the conference is pretty good compared to how the season started.
Yeah, for sure. It wasn't the greatest start for them, but I think they're starting to roll into their rhythm a bit.
Jack Yeomans bringing the ball down the court here for the Falcons. And that layup is up and no good. DeMarco Owens not able to get the rebound, but the Falcons are able to get the rebound. And Wade Lohman gets the first 2 points of the day for the Falcons. Falcons very aggressive on the boards there.
Looked like Lohman may have been a little tripped up or something. He called in for a sub.
Falcons making a quick substitution. Jeremiah Curtis will come into the game.
Yeah, Lohman looks a little injured. That's not good.
He'll be walking up the court. He is seeing the trainer over there back behind us. So hope the best for him. That would be a big hit to this Falcons team if he's not able to return.
But we got some of our bigger guys in right now with DeMarco and with Jeremiah Curtis just now checking in. So.
That's good for the Falcons too, especially with the size differential that you hit on earlier on in the game. And a deep three there. This one is off the mark. And Jack Yeomans, the freshman guard, will pick up and bring it down the court. He makes a good move. And DeMarco Owens looking to go up with it. He'll actually pass it out to Jeremiah Curtis. That shot is up and good. And
that
Jeremiah Curtis is a fantastic player. And with the size that he has, he shoots it very well from outside the paint.
I like watching the two of them work together. They're both big guys. Like, they're both tall, but they're also just very powerful players. So
I like, and good the defense there from the Falcons, but a foul is ended up being called. And they call it on the shot, so two shots for Christian Brothers as they will go to the line.
Shooting two for Christian Brothers. Number 20, Nick Dyfer.
Christian Brothers, a very good free throw percentage shooting team, averaging 76% on the season. And both free throws are up and good as well. So Christian Brothers will tie this game back up at four. Just a little over 2 minutes going in this first half. Falcons moving the ball around the perimeter. You see the two big guys down low just kind of hanging out. But a good look right there, as you pointed out.
To DeMarco Owens.
That's something that you would have to assume that the Falcons look at here with playing kind of big right here, looking to take the ball down low on offense.
Yeah, I think that's what we're going to see a lot of, especially with guys like Jack Yeomans and Micah Fuller that are playing on the backcourt for them, who are both really good passers.
Right, and so both teams right here, Christian Brothers averaging 75 points a game, Montevallo averaging 67 points a game. You would expect a lot of back and forth like we've seen through these first few possessions.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Michael Fuller with another good look to the corner there. That shot is no good. Christian Brothers will be able to pick up the rebound.
Even with a miss, I like to see a shot like that. That was just a good
look. Good open shot. Mm-hmm. And good pass right there from Christian Brothers. And that goes right back to what we were talking about. Christian Brothers averaging 17.8 assists per game so far this season. Good move there from Michael Fuller. Quick step back. This one no good as the Falcons look to make another substitution early on as Cam Copeland looks to check in.
Number one, Cam Copeland. I'm interested to see why he's coming in as late as he is. It seems like he was usually a starter. So.
The Falcons making another substitution as well. Zach Jackson looking to check in. Zach Jackson is a guy that he's not necessarily your tallest player.
Right.
But he's a guy that can go up and really get aggressive down low.
He's a very middle type player. He can play up, he can play down, he can be a point guard if needed. He's very versatile.
And so DeMarco Owens goes up for the and one opportunity there as we head to our first media timeout. This game tied at eight. A lot of back and forth so far. The Falcons will be able to go to the line to try and retake the lead. What is one thing you want to see from the Falcons a little bit differently on offense, or on defense, to try and stop this high-powered Christian Brothers offense?
Better rebounding. I think better rebounding right now, and just a little more being able to mark up whose man is whose and all of that. So there's been a lot of long shots. So need to contest those as
well. We've seen a lot of substitutions from the Falcons so far early. Do you think that's more or less because they're trying to run with this Christian Brothers team, or just trying to create different continuity?
I think they're just playing around with what's working right now. They don't really, that's every team is different. So I think for them, they're just trying to see, who's going to work against Christian Brothers. So.
So the Falcons going to the free throw line for the first time so far this game. The Falcons have been pretty good free throw shooting teams, but especially this year, the Falcons are one of the top free throw shooting teams in the country at getting to the line. The Falcons ranked 58th in the NCAA and first in the Gulf South Conference in total free throw attempts, having attempted 318 free throws on the season, about to be 319 with this and one opportunity. And this past game against West Florida, the Falcons went 15 of 17. This is huge for the Falcons' offense to try and continue to get the ball down low to their bigs and continue to get to the lines they have done all season.
For sure.
So DeMarco Owens will head to the line here for the Falcons. His free throw is up and good. And DeMarco Owens now has five of the Falcons' first 9 points, having a good game so far.
Owens is one of those big men that's consistently a good free throw shooter, which is what you need.
So the Falcons playing a little bit more small ball now, still playing man-to-man on defense,
yeah.
But maybe something that needs to be a little bit quicker with this Christian Brothers offense or defense as well. And you would assume that Zach Jackson is most likely going to have to play the four or the forward position in this case here.
Yeah,
Cam Copeland there with
Jeremiah Curtis is the only true big man in
right
now. So
most likely see a lot more perimeter ball as we see.
Copeland is so quick, though. I think that
Yeoman's with a good shot there.
Shot.
But I agree. The Falcons have switched to more of a quick based offense right here with these with the small ball rotation.
Yeah, I think Micah Fuller, Cam Copeland, and Jack Yeoman are all three just really, really fast guys. So there's going to be a lot of...
There it is again, the back and forth that we continue to talk about. And we talk about the small ball rotation for the Falcons being very fast, but Chris Brothers has almost the exact same thing.
Yeah, they do. And none of their guys are, like, particularly huge either.
No.
So they look like they have a little bit of speed as well.
Christian Brothers playing very aggressive around the perimeter. Falcons trying to get it inside as they have done all day as they find Zach Jackson. He goes up.
Curtis
He'll get
outside.
The pass to Curtis. And Curtis has really done well so far this game. Now has 7 points. Falcons with 13. He's been the main source on offense so far.
7 points coming off the bench too. Good defense there by Copeland.
Excuse me, that was Curtis. Curtis has 4 points, not seven.
Oh, okay.
Seven was DeMarco Owens. Either way, both big men are playing very well so far.
Very well so far.
And good defense there from this Falcons, specifically Jack Yeomans.
So Fuller, you can see now that Copeland is in, is not taking the point position, going back on a wing.
A deep three here from Jack Yeomans. That one will be out, and Coach Danny Young is not happy with that shot right there. The Falcons, no passes on that. Just a really deep, not necessarily smart shot right there from Yeomans. Falcons looking to make two more subs here as Carl Johnson comes back in, and Tyler Updike will come in as well. Updike is another one of those guys who is not necessarily big, but he's quick and can get you that outside shot on this offense.
He is definitely one of the Falcons' better shooters. I think transfer from UNC Wilmington coming out, and I just remember last game I was at, he just knocked down 3-4 shots in a row from the outside. So
good aggressive defense there from Zach Jackson, but eventually it will be a foul on him because Christian Brothers is finding a way to keep on moving around inside the paint and getting up. Falcons essentially about to sub their whole rotation out here, bringing in four subs.
Owens and Lohman also coming off, yep.
Good to see Wade being able to come back in the game, though.
For sure, yeah. Glad he's okay. And number five, Aiden Ruthas, is going to be coming in for the Buccaneers.
So the Falcons kind of switching back to that bigger rotation now. They played small ball for a couple minutes. Didn't necessarily work on offense. Now they're going to try and switch to this big man rotation, see if that will work. And you would assume that Cam Copeland will continue to bring the ball down for the court, down the court for the Falcons.
Yeah. Owens coming back in at center. Updike now on the wing.
Copeland with a good look there.
Good look by him.
And a good offensive rebound, but still not able to get it follow as Owens. And so Christian Brothers will bring the ball back down the court, looking to tie it up at 13 or maybe take their lead.
Copeland, like Nautica Philpott, who we saw in the women's game, is just one of those players that creates offense, you know.
Sees the court very well.
Very well, yeah.
Christian Brothers also, basically everybody on their team sees the court very well.
Yeah.
5 seconds left on the shot clock here. They'll pull up. That shot, no good, and a good aggressive rebound there. Falcons looking to push it down the court to extend their lead.
Copeland swings it.
Falcons looking to move the ball. They get it outside to Johnson for three. That three is a little long, and the Falcons again not able to pull up and down an offensive rebound. Christian Brothers brings it back down the court. Good aggressive defense here from the Falcons, and a reach-in will be called there on Carl Johnson. So a foul called there on Carl Johnson, and really it looked like he almost got the ball, but he did still get the hand, but you have to like the aggressive defense from the Falcons here so far.
Mm-hmm.
So the Falcons up 13-11, 12 minutes to go in the half. We'll take our first break, and we'll be right back here with you on the Montevallo for You Network. Is there anything you want to hit on?
No, I don't think so.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you. Rebounds. Back here in Trustmark Arena, the Falcons currently holding a 13-11 advantage over the Christian Brothers Buccaneers. 12 minutes to go so far in the half. DeMarco Owens leading all scorers so far with 5 points. Three seconds left on the shot clock. They'll have to put up a deep three. They get the three off, and it is no good. And the Falcons with a good rebound there. Carl Johnson will bring it down the court for the Falcons. He's looking to go coast to coast. He goes up. That two is no good. He gets his own rebound, though, and the Falcons will set up shop at the top of the key. Good movement there from the Falcons. That three is in and out from Carl Johnson. Again, gets his own rebound. Goes up for the reverse layup, and the Falcons not able to find anything there on offense.
I'm surprised. I thought there might be a foul call on Carl Johnson right there, but just not.
And another deep three there from Christian Brothers. Neither one of these teams so far is getting the ball to fall, despite having been able to score a lot of points so far throughout the season.
Yeah.
That three. This time the Falcons get it to fall. So there is the three right there for number one, Cam Copeland, the junior out of Toledo, Ohio. Cam's first 3 points of the game.
That looked good, too. That was a good just response to everything happening.
Falcons looking to check Jeremiah Curtis and Michael Fuller back into the game. And the Falcons will be very upset with that one right there, because that is a 5'8 guard that goes inside your big man and pulls up the rebound.
Yep. Snuck inside. I was wondering how tall that guy is, but yeah.
So the Falcons bringing in Micah Fuller and Jeremiah Curtis. Carl Johnson and DeMarco Owens will take a breather. Falcons currently holding a 5-point advantage, 10 minutes to go in the half. Christian Brothers taking it inside, and they get the and one opportunity there. Christian Brothers has been very aggressive at getting the ball down low and trying to draw the foul throughout this entire game so far. That free throw is up and good. Both of these teams, while not necessarily playing each other a lot, both have very experienced head coaches. Coach Danny Young in his 16th season with the Falcons, and then Coach Mike Nienbar for Christian Brothers in his 19th year. So,
oh wow,
it's a lot of experience between these two coaches. Cam's shot is up and no good. So Christian Brothers, again, will have the chance to come down the court and try and either tie up the game at 16 or take it the lead with a three. Mm-hmm. If you're the Falcons here on defense, what are you looking to do?
Get a steal.
Yeah, I think we'd all like that. Yeah. Or we'll take a missed shot like that right there. And Cam Copeland, the guard with the rebound, will bring it down for the Falcons. Send over to Micah Fuller for the three. This one is no good, but a great rebound there
by Lohman.
The two is up and no good. The Falcons, though, being very aggressive on the board so far early is what you like to see.
Yeah.
And a good finger roll right there for Christian Brothers. This will tie this game up at 16, 8.5 minutes to go in the half.
That was not the drive inside the Falcons wanted to let go.
No, not at all. Especially when you have somebody like DeMarco Owens and Wade Lohman downside.
Exactly.
And again, the Falcons not able to find the ball inside. Is it? Do you think it's just the offensive rotation or the shots? What is it that the Falcons are doing that can't get the ball inside the hoop so far?
There's a bit of frustration right now overall. And I mean, even though they're tied up, they're, I don't know. I wouldn't say they're hanging their heads at all, but they just seem to be frustrated right now. We said the women's team was comfortable today. The men's team looked a bit uncomfortable.
I would completely agree with that. Neither team really has gotten into their groove so far.
No.
Falcons passing around the perimeter again. Cam Copeland's jumper is good. That was a good shot right there from the elbow.
Yeah, not usually a shooter for the Falcons, but today just knocked down a few good jumpers, and that looked good.
Coach Danny Young, we heard him walk across in front of us here a second ago, looking for more ball pressure on defense to not allow this good passing team to be able to get good smart passes off.
Yeah.
And right there is exactly what Coach wanted. Yep. You saw Michael Fuller up top on the key, forced a bad pass right there, forced a turnover, and the Falcons get the ball back with a two-point advantage. So the Falcons with a two-point lead, up 18-16. Neither team has been very efficient at getting the ball in the hoop. Both teams have been pretty even on the boards so far. So what is it that you think you probably need to see from the Falcons to try and expand their two-point lead?
Expand the lead? I think better passing overall on offense. And then defense, you know, we talked about a lot, just heavier guarding the man and guarding the man without the ball, too. We saw Fuller's man just cut through very quickly, and Fuller just kind of lost him really, really quickly. Obviously, the point didn't turn over for them, but those are just simple things they can do, just staying on their man and also pressuring the ball a little heavier, too.
And then we saw on offense early on in the game, the Falcons continuously went down to DeMarco Owens and Jeremiah Curtis, but now you see that the Falcons are taking more shots from the elbow, more shots from the perimeter. Do you think the Falcons need to try and get it back down inside, or are you okay with the shots that they're taking now?
I like the shots that the Falcons are taking right now. I think that a guy like Cam Copeland that can just knock down a nice, easy jumper. A lot of the shots that they've missed today, even, I thought they were good shots. A lot of the ones from the side that just didn't fall, and sometimes shots don't fall, but I think that it's better to have an educated shot and a shot that kind of, you know, hits the front of the rim than just throwing something up, obviously. So, see Zach Jackson is back in.
So the five for the Falcons now is Jack Yeomans, Micah Fuller, Zach Jackson, Carl Johnson, and Jeremiah Curtis.
Move inside by Johnson.
Good ball movement around the perimeter for the Falcons. Johnson passes it outside to Fuller for the three. That one is good. Great ball movement right there from the Falcons. Now puts it the Falcons just 2 for 6 so far from three as Christian Brothers gets their own three and they answer right back to make it a 2-point game again. Falcons looking for ball movement around the perimeter. See, they're kind of bigs, just kind of sitting down low on the box, waiting for the ball. Just like that to Jeremiah Curtis. That two is up, no good. And Zach Jackson right there, although that ball went off of him, though that those hops that he had right there, even though he's a smaller guy, that's why they're okay with him playing the four.
For sure. Yeah. See, Owen's going to be checking in.
Joe LaVario brings the ball down the court for Christian Brothers.
Christian Brothers definitely setting a lot of picks, and you can see the guy, our guy, is not really making the transition between man, but rather staying on them, so there's a lot of running after.
Yeah, Falcons have to do a better job of finding a way to roll off of those picks.
For sure, yep. Good shot attempt by Yeomans, did not fall. Jack, what is
that? So that's a couple shots now that, even though that was a good-looking shot, that Coach Danny Young really hasn't been happy with from the freshman.
No.
And a three right there from Christian Brothers, and that one is good again. Christian Brothers now finding a way to roll on offense was something they weren't able to do at the beginning of the game.
Yeah, that was a good-looking shot, and it was a little bit not the best defense by us there.
The ball pressure that Coach Danny Young has asked for has kind of gone away again. That's where
for
their
sure.
offense has kind of
yep.
opened up.
Yep.
Michael Fuller looking to take it inside. A good move, but a travel is called instead. So the Falcons now a little bit discombobulated on both sides of the ball, and Christian Brothers now starting to get a little bit more comfortable.
Yep.
Cam Copeland and DeMarco Owens will check back into the game.
Fuller back up top, being the key. Or the point guard, rather. Owens man outside the perimeter.
And good, another good off-ball screen there by Christian Brothers. The Falcons are able to pick up the rebound, though. Fuller brings it down the court. He's got Johnson out wide. Didn't see him, though. But Johnson makes a good move inside. Loses the ball. But a good move right there by DeMarco Owens. Owens now with 7 points on the day to get the Falcons down. Just back by one, 24-23, 4.5 minutes remaining in the half. And another screen, that could essentially have been a moving screen there, not called against Christian Brothers. That three is up, no good. A deep rebound will be gained by the Falcons. The Falcons now going down the court looking to take the lead. And a good look there from Copeland to find Fuller in the corner. That three is in and out. And the Falcons able to get the offensive rebound on set up shop. There's Carl Johnson on the corner. No good again. The Falcons again with another offensive rebound.
There
and this
is.
Time they get it to fall. Falcons very good about crashing the boards there to retake the lead.
Yeah, they had a lot of good attempts there, but it finally fell. So. Glad they were able to get the ball back.
And again, continuously, Christian Brothers finds way to score points off of the screens.
Yeah, Falcons are going to have to change up what they're doing with the screens, either whether that be changing men immediately when the screen is called or...
So the Falcons now with the ball. Zach Jackson looking to take it inside. He does. No shot. They will call the foul on the floor. Looks like that could have gone either way. The official decided to call it on the floor. However, you have to like the ball movement from the Falcons there.
Yeah, that looked good.
So we head into our media timeout. The Falcons down 27-25. 3 minutes to go in the half, and we'll be right back with you on the Montevallo for You Network. We'll be right back. back here in Trustmark Arena. The Falcons currently down 27-25, inbounding the ball from below the basket here. Falcons need to get it in for the 5 seconds. They get it to DeMarco Owens. Find Tyler Updike at the top of the key. Updike will take a three. This one is off, and almost a foul there from DeMarco Owens. Good move right there, and the Falcons have almost, they're lost on defense now.
Yeah, just lost their man there. That's going to have to be something that changes next half.
Falcons looking to go back inside as they did early in the game. Christian Brothers being very aggressive, but DeMarco Owens having a good game, not being able to make that shot. And again, the Falcons leave that side of the court with no points on the board. That three is up and good, and Christian Brothers is just rolling on offense now, and you can kind of feel it from the Falcons bench that the vibe they had going has kind of gone away now.
Yeah, for sure.
So this shot is up and good. The Falcons finally get one to fall. It's Carl Johnson, and despite only being down by 5 points, it feels like Christian Brothers is kind of outplaying the Falcons.
Our problem right now isn't our offense. Our offense is good. It's just defensively we're just getting beat every time.
Every time.
I think that's a bit discouraging for everybody, even though it is, like you said, a small lead. But
so if you're the Falcons here, do you think that on-ball pressure is really what they need to do to try and create these bad passes and not allow Chris Brothers to set their screens?
Either heavier pressure on the ball or heavier pressure on your man. I don't know. I guess probably on the ball right now.
So the Falcons bring the ball down, back down the court, down by 5. Minute 15 remaining in the half. Michael Fuller.
But I think what they need to do, too, is, with so many picks, they need to be able to adapt to not necessarily guarding one person, but guarding everybody.
Correct. So this shot is up and good. And, again, Jeremiah Curtis. So it's just such a good shooter from the elbow right there.
For sure.
And a foul called there on the Falcons. Someone will be called on Jeremiah Curtis.
First of all, number 22, Jeremiah Curtis. His first personal team foul, number 6.
Christian Brothers will call a timeout here. So we head almost into halftime here. 45 seconds to go. The Falcons down by 3. If you're the Falcons here, what do you look at? What's do you want to have momentum going into the half?
If they can finish with the score, that would be terrific for them, I think, right now. Even if they don't tie it up necessarily, even if they just make a two-pointer, go into the locker room feeling that little bit of confidence. Or on the other side, if they stop the ball, I think that would also be a really big
I think if you're the Falcons, you have to at least keep this within one possession.
For
because
sure.
Christian Brothers could make two more threes here as they've done all game. They can make one here, Falcons miss one, do another one. Now the next thing you know, it's a three-possession game. So, like you said, the Falcons don't have to have the lead. They don't even have to be tied.
Yeah.
But as long as it's within one possession, it's at least manageable in the second half
for
starts.
Sure. This is such a lower scoring game than the women's game.
A lot lower scoring.
Very unusual in basketball, but
5 seconds now on the shot clock for Christian Brothers. They'll take a deep three. This one is up, and that one is long from the start. But Christian Brothers is able to get a good offensive rebound. Another open three, and this one is good. This time from number 24, Luke Rudy. His 6th point of the game, and that's essentially what we're talking about right there. So the Falcons will hold for the last shot here. And a foul called on Christian Brothers.
First foul, number 11, Joe Larry. First personal team foul, number 3.
So the Falcons bringing in a shooter here in Jack Gilman's, you would assume. The Falcons probably don't have to have it on the perimeter, but it would at least want 2 points here. Falcons looking to set up their play. Michael Fuller is fouled at the top of the key. 2.2 seconds now remaining in the half.
Will he go to the line?
Not yet. So the Falcons will have to have a catch and shoot here with 2 seconds to go. Falcons need to get it in. They do get it to Yeomans. He'll get the two off. This one is no good.
That'll
so
fall short.
The Falcons not able to keep it within one possession, but they do allow Christian Brothers not to be able to bring it back down and extend their lead.
For sure.
Falcons down 35-29 going into the second half. What do you need to see differently from the Falcons overall going into the second half?
They need to shut down their offense. Christian Brothers offense is very dangerous, how they're able to make these, you know, looking to really –
When that shot was made, like when that shot was taken, how much time was on the shot clock?
I didn't see the shot clock. All I saw was the game clock.
Welcome back into Trustmark Arena. I'm joined by head men's lacrosse coach Jason Lang. Coach, second year of the program, second year as a head coach. Just talk about going into the second season, what you look to build off from the inaugural season.
Yeah, I think, you know, the biggest thing for us is consistency. You know, last year we played, there were some games where we were great in all facets, and then there were some games where we weren't great. A lot of peaks and valleys. So we're hoping this year to build off of the consistency of our good performances last year.
And what are your expectations or goals going into this season?
So, you know, for us it was a goal last year that we did not accomplish, but making the conference tournament and having a winning record. So last year we were fortunate to finish 500. But losing two goals in overtime, or two games in overtime by a goal each, you know, didn't allow us to accomplish those goals.
You returned several players from last year's roster, including Kyle Little, who is conference goalkeeper of the year. Just talk about some of these newcomers coming back, and specifically Kyle Little.
Yeah, so Kyle's awesome. He's one of the hardest working guys in our program. And we're very fortunate to have him. He's a great goaltender, and he's also a great leader. And as good of a player he is, I think he's a better teammate and a better person. We're also excited for the return of Cordell Primus, who had a season-ending injury last fall. So he's been playing well, and Thomas Vason as well. All have been playing very well for us throughout the fall and into the spring.
And Coach, what are you most excited about with the group of freshmen and newcomers you brought into this team?
I think especially on the defensive side of the ball, it's the athleticism. We're athletic down there. We're mean. We can go out and get people. Offensively, we added more depth. Last year, we only played about six midfielders, seven midfielders. I think we could go 9 or 10 deep this year. So we're very excited for that.
Awesome. Coach, thank you for joining us here, and good luck to the season.
Absolutely. Thank you very much.
Yes, sir. And now we'll get a chance to talk to Thomas Vazen. And Thomas, you're entering your sophomore season, second year as a program. What are you looking to build off of from the inaugural season last year?
I mean, I'm looking to build the whole team's process, you know what I mean? So from last season, we were a young team. We got new kids, new talent in this year. So hopefully we can kind of, I mean, work off, build off last year talent-wise, and like moving the ball more. Consistency is a big one for us. We got to, last year was like iffy. We lost a couple overtime games that we definitely should have won. So I think if we can capitalize on our chances more, me personally, I want to be capitalizing on my shots and my chances that I, when I get opportunities in front of the net, I need to bury on them and hopefully win a couple more games this season for sure.
So what are the overall goals you have for yourself personally this season and for the team?
I mean, for me personally, last year I made second team all conference. Maybe this year I want to jump up to first team. I want to get more points for myself, but maybe more in the assist column this season. And then for the team, I think if we can come together more as a team, bond, and like I said, we got new guys, new talent. If we can get everybody involved and work together, I think we'll be a much more successful team this year.
You mentioned the new guys coming in. What are you most excited about with the new teammates you have this season?
Oh, it's really exciting. I mean, new guys, everyone's got a different playing style, right? So when new guys come in, it's like a different style, different game almost, you know? So at least from our perspective on the field, like, it's exciting to play with different players, get different like opportunities, chances, and see what kind of, I mean, it's going to be fun. It's going to be a lot of fun.
All right. Well, Thomas, thank you for joining us here, and good luck to the season. All right, well, thank you for joining us here during halftime as we preview the men's lacrosse 2019 season. Be sure to check them out, and we'll be back here in Trustmark Arena for the second half of action between Montevallo and Christian Brothers.
Solid.
17-7 Chiefs.
Halftime sheet yet, you know?
Thank you.
Dang. Everybody for us is in the minus. Well, yeah, that's true.
All right, you ready? Let's do it. Back here in Trustmark Arena to start the second half between the Montevallo Falcons and the Christian Brothers Buccaneers. The Falcons down 35-29 to start this half. However, despite being down by six, this game has changed lead changes six times.
Wow, yeah.
The Falcons have had the lead seven times as Christian Brothers goes right away and adds two more points there. Both teams had 12 points in the paint at half. Both teams had around 6 points, second chance points. 13 bench points for the Falcons, 11 bench points for Christian Brothers, 20 rebounds for the Falcons, and 19 rebounds for Christian Brothers. So despite being down at six, despite being down by six and a half, this game is a lot closer than what it really seems.
Yeah, for sure. I think that, they're not even down by that much, really, and then in men's basketball terms, unless the lead is over 10 points, I really don't consider it to be, you know, a substantial deficit. So.
Right. And so now, even with that quick two right there for Christian Brothers to go up by eight, that's the biggest lead that either one of these teams has had the entire game.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, I think that both teams are, you know, very, very evenly matched today, and I think that Falcons are going to do well and get the ball.
So the Falcons went
back up on the board.
So. The Falcons went back to their starting five as well, so you would assume that this is rotation that they'd like to have.
Yeah, you would hope. I mean, hopefully these are the guys.
Great rebound right there by Wade Loman, by the way.
God.
But you were saying?
Nah. Sorry, Wade, he's so long, though, Wade Loman. He's just such a long player, and, like, he's just able to, like, get these rebounds that, like, a lot of other players can't. And he's very, even though he's a bigger man, big man, he's very athletic, you know, to be able to get up there. And
so Christian Brothers, though, goes down and gets two more points right back on the board. So that's two possessions and two scores for Christian Brothers to keep their lead at 8 points. And aggressive defense there for Christian Brothers leads to a foul. Falcons essentially would like to take the ball inside the paint as they have done all game. Jack Yeomans with a nice pump fake there, and his two is
That's
up and good.
Good.
A great move right there from Jack Yeomans to create a good-looking shot.
Good shot there by Yeomans for sure. I like that he moved to the opportunity, too. That looked really good.
I think that's one thing the Falcons need to do on offense more is, instead of forcing up a three, move
right,
to the opportunity
to the,
like you know, like you mentioned.
Jump shot, yeah.
And a great block right there by Wade Loman. That's that extension of the arms that you mentioned earlier when you got the good rebound. Falcons have the momentum now. Would like to get 2 points on the board after that great block. The reverse, no good. Loman himself goes up again for two more points.
And that was a great dish right there by Fuller to start that play as well.
Exactly. So Wade Loman having himself a great second half to start off so far.
I'd say so.
That three is up, and Christian Brothers answers right back again with a three of their own. So as we were talking about Wade Loman a second ago and the good second half that he's having so far, he leads the Falcons in offensive rebounds per game, averaging 3.5 per game, putting him first in the Gulf South and 17th in the entire country in the NCAA.
Yeah.
So that's the extension of his body that you said where he can go inside and get those is exactly what you're talking about that leads him to being one of the best rebounders in the country.
Yeah, Loman is definitely a guy that's good for the Falcons as far as crashing the boards.
And a bad foul right there by the Falcons. As we continue talking about the rebounds, though, that the Falcons have done well with so far this season.
Shooting three for Christian Brothers, number 11, Joe Larrabee.
So it looks like Carl Johnson will come out and Cam Copeland will check in for him.
So we continue talking about those rebounds that the Falcons have done well with so far all game and really all season. The Falcons are a top rebounding team in the country, really. So they have totaled, before this game, they came into the game with 600 rebounds on the season, putting them 25th in the entire country, which is huge.
It's very big for us, yeah.
So So as you said, Cam Copeland will check into the game. And all three free throws right there for Christian Brothers are good, but again, that's probably something you expect, a 76% shooting team from the charity stripe.
Yeah, it's almost more, I mean, in college, at a level this high, it's more surprising when you see people miss free throws.
Exactly.
Make them, so.
Michael Fuller, again, like you said, moving to the opportunity there, has his shot blocked, and this one will go off of the Falcons.
Tyler Updike now checking in for the Falcons.
Tyler Updike.
Both teams coming into this game averaging 2.1 blocks per game, and we've seen two quick ones from either side to start this second half.
Falcons playing now with three guards down low, so or up top rather, sorry.
Jack Yeomans, Cam Copeland, and Tyler Updike are the guards in for the Falcons.
Apply that pressure.
That ball pressure coach has been asking for.
And that was some pressure right there, even though the shot got off. That's a long three that they just took, so.
And throughout this game, Christian Brothers has made a lot of the open threes. They haven't made the contested threes. So like you said, if they can continue to force them to shoot those long threes, I'm sure that's something that Coach Young wouldn't be too upset with.
Right.
Updike with a three of his own. No foul called. And that's essentially something that they called on the exact other side of the court. And Christian Brothers went for three. And a technical foul called on somebody from the Falcons bench right there. And Coach Young is not happy right there going down to talk to the players. So to go over that situation real quick, Christian Brothers had a three a moment ago that was called a foul. Mm-hmm. And they went to the line for three, and the Falcons essentially had the exact same thing, got hit the exact same way, no foul called. And so then players from the Falcons bench started asking why the foul was not called, probably said something wrong, which then led to a technical foul against the Falcons, which essentially hurts them because now it puts them down by 10 points.
Yep. Arguing with officials as a player really just never does much good, and
especially when you're on the bench.
Yes, yeah.
So the Falcons now down 10. It's the first double-digit lead of the game for either team. Christian Brothers has come out this second half a lot hotter, a lot faster, a lot more quicker on the offensive side of the ball. What is it that you need to see from the Falcons defensively to try and keep this game within 10 points?
Well, I haven't seen as much of the screen play from the offense or from the Christian Brothers team this game, but I think the one thing for sure is that they need to continue to rebound as they've been doing. So
Falcons just seem a little bit discombobulated, like you said. The women came into the game when they played against Christian Brothers a couple hours ago extremely comfortable,
right?
Knew what they wanted to do. The men's team hasn't really been comfortable yet this entire game.
Yeah, I agree with that for sure.
So now Christian Brothers inbounding the ball from the far side of the court, currently holding that 10-point lead, 15 and a half minutes to go in the game. Christian Brothers shooting 7 of 21 from behind the line. And there's another one, and no foul called this time. And the Falcons trying to find something on the offensive side of the ball. Updike will take a three of his own, and this one is good.
That looks good.
The Falcons make just their third three of the game out of 13 attempts, but something that the offense desperately needed.
For sure.
And Christian Brothers finds a wide open three there. They're not able to answer. But again, the 5'8 guard for Christian Brothers continues to find a way inside this Falcons defense, creating second chance opportunities for Christian Brothers. Mm. And a good reverse layup there to get it to fall for Christian Brothers. Do you think just because of the size of the 5'8 guard for Christian Brothers, that's number five.
Right.
Aiden Rustaz, just because of his size, is it easy for him to get inside the paint without the Falcons noticing?
I think he's just, yeah, he's almost someone that people aren't going to expect to get inside the paint, and then he does, and it's just like unexpected for sure. But yeah, his size definitely plays an advantage there as well. So.
And essentially right there too, Aiden Rustaz sitting at 5'8", it's going to be hard for him to guard Wade Loman.
Oh, yeah.
One of the best rebounders in the country. So yeah. Essentially that's why that foul is basically called on him, because he has no chance really against Wade.
Right.
Jeremiah Curtis checks back in for the Falcons, for DeMarco Owens. Falcons need to find a way to get it in. They do. Curtis goes up. That two is no good. Gets his own rebound, but steps on the line. And the Falcons will head back down on defense, still down by nine. Ten seconds right there called on Christian Brothers. And that right there, the ball pressure that you talk about, the quick, the three-man press right there, you don't see 10 seconds called often. So
no, you don't.
For 10 seconds to be called shows how great that defensive possession was for the Falcons.
That was a great defense for them. That might be a way for them almost to disrupt all the problems they were having with the picks too. You know?
Exactly. So. That's a good way to try and get them to gain some sort of momentum on defense.
Yeah.
Especially since Christian Brothers is shooting so well this half. And Christian Brothers, like just like that right there, finding ways to get inside this defense. Yeomans with the ball on the wing. Would set it up top. Falcons will round the wing again. Essentially the same raw offense they've been running all game, and a bad pass right there from Tyler Updike. Christian Brothers will look to extend their lead once again as they head to the corner. This three is way long. An air ball right there, and the Falcons will transition quick down the court. Will Jack Yeomans, and a
look out to
dangerous pass. Yeomans takes his own three. No good. And again, neither one of the coaches from either team very happy. Christian Brothers, despite being up by 11, not necessarily moving the ball that they want to. And Aiden Rustaz, again, the 5'8 guard, has really found a way around this defense. Good passes there from the Falcons. Zach Jackson and Micah Ford checking in for the Falcons. So the Falcons just really seem discombobulated. They can't find a way to make it smooth and continuous on both sides of the ball. So if you're the Falcons here, what sort of momentum do you need just to make things just start going smooth for you?
Well, I think that defense was a really good start, and unfortunately you didn't see it again. But playing good defense can definitely bring about good momentum and forcing turnovers. But then things like this too, where you just have good plays by different players. Zach Jackson there making a good play and
getting himself the end one opportunity.
Yeah.
With the shot clock going off as well. So a good job right there to get inside the lane.
Yes.
To even if he doesn't make the layup, draw the contact to get
for
to the
sure.
line.
And even if you don't, you know, like he didn't make the layup, you still force the foul, and that's another foul on a player.
Exactly,
you know,
and it would get Christian Brothers closer to being in the bonus as well, which would get the Falcons to the charity stripe even more.
Yep.
And so an off-ball foul will be called here. Actually, no foul call. Something flew onto the court. So Christian Brothers will start back over.
It was at 20. Why did you reset it?
Fuck.
So Christian Brothers had brought the ball down the court until an object came on to the court with about 20 seconds left, and the shot clock was reset when it shouldn't have been, and four more seconds had run off of it. So being at 20, it moved back down to 16, and a great block right there again by Wade Loman.
He's having a heck of a defensive game.
And that was going to be a big dunk, too, from Christian Brothers. And a good look there from Fuller. And Loman in for the end one opportunity.
Good job by
Wade Loman again. Like you said, a great job there to find an inside. And again, like you mentioned earlier, the ability by Michael Fuller as a guard to find him down low to go up for the end one opportunity. So the Falcons now down just 53-44. Head to the line for an end one opportunity.
This will be the momentum, hopefully, that they need right now.
This is exactly what we were talking about. And if you can make this free throw right here, go down by just 8, and then be able to stop Christian Brothers on defense, come down and score again, that's what's really going to get the crowd back into it and get your offense pumping yet again.
I agree.
We've talked about it all game, but Wade Loman having a great game, especially a great second half for the Falcons.
And he's been here when we needed him, too.
Exactly.
I think, so.
And he leads the team in field goal percentage for the season at 58%. So he's a guy that, even if he doesn't take a lot of shots, when he does, they're smart shots that he knows at least have a chance of going in.
He's a very consistent player.
That free throw up short, not able to get it to fall for the Falcons, so the Falcons now just 2 of 4 from the free throw line. We mentioned earlier, the Falcons one of the best teams in the country getting to the line. Haven't done it a lot so far today.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Falcons need a stop here on defense. Not able to get the rebound there.
Rebound,
and again,
right into his hands.
Another second chance opportunity for Christian Brothers. Christian Brothers with the 9-point lead, 11 minutes to go in the game. They find yet another open three. And again with another offensive rebound for Christian Brothers. This three is up, and that one is good. So right there kills the momentum that we were just talking about, because they had three opportunities there on that side of the court to score, and all of them came from behind the arc and were all open shots as well.
Yep.
And Zach Jackson's not even really paying attention right there. That pass bounces off of his face. And a hold will be called on Michael Fuller on the floor. The Falcons just don't really know what's going on right now. It was a good look from Fuller to Zach Jackson. But Zach wasn't really looking for it. Bounced off of his face, which forced the turnover.
Yeah.
At number 33,
so Christian Brothers looking to extend their lead once again, currently up by 12. This one goes up and will be off of the Falcons. Biggest lead for Christian Brothers so far is 13. They had that just a couple minutes ago, actually, here in the second half. 10 and a half to go in the game now. The shot up, no good.
Good
Falcons.
Rebound.
There you said it right there, especially from the guard too,
yeah,
and Jack
exactly.
Yeomans. And a good look there from Copeland. That two up, no good.
Fire.
And that could have been an over the back foul right there, but not called. Michael Fuller looking to check in for the Falcons.
Just a short breather for him.
he's a guy that the Falcons need on the court.
Yeah, I would agree.
And an easy 2 points right there for Christian Brothers. They found a good lane right there. Now extending their lead to 14, 58 to 44. Wade Lohman again gets his own rebound and puts it back up for two. Lohman again having a fantastic game. And a block there will be called on Wade at the top of the key. Michael Fuller checks into the game for Cam Copeland for the Falcons. And Christian Brothers will make two subs of their own. Number 33, Adam Dieball, and number 24, Luke Rudy come in for the Buccaneers. If you're the Falcons here, as Christian Brothers finds another open three, and they again get yet another offensive rebound. If you're the Falcons, what do you look to do to stop this Christian Brothers offense?
I think that the offense right now is they're running a very fast-paced offense right now. I don't know how our guys can keep up with it, but the biggest thing right now is rebounds, and unfortunately, we've been losing a lot of those.
And Christian Brothers has now really find their spot behind the arc again with another three. Now up by 17, 61 to 46. Falcons need to make a big run here. Good aggressive defense there from the Buccaneers. And a region foul called right there on number 20, Nick Dieffel. Zach Jackson will inbound the ball for the Falcons below the hoop. And over the head of Wade Lohman.
Wade is not going to let that one go easy, but.
No, he will not. But 2 points right there to extend their lead to 19 now for Christian Brothers. And the Falcons, now down 19, really need to find something on offense before this one really starts to get out of their hands. Good move right there in the backhanded finger roll from Michael Fuller for 2 points.
Get something going there.
Michael Fuller now, that was his fifth point of the game. And a good block right there from the Falcons. Christian Brothers looking for a foul, not called. Zach Jackson take the ball inside himself, hands it off
passes
to Wade.
It to Lohman.
And a block called right there on Christian Brothers. And this will take us to our media timeout. So the Falcons down 63 to 48, 7:24 to go in the game, and we'll be right back here on the Montevallo for You Network.
Hey, we got 7,000 of both. Did they do one?
Hey, Jake said they have hot dogs.
Upstairs?
Yeah.
Okay.
From an Albuquerque.
Probably no interview after this game since we're gonna lose probably.
So back here in Trustmark Arena, the Falcons down 63-48, a little over 7 minutes to go. Falcons haven't had a whole lot of offense so far in the second half. Is that first free throw from Yeomans and the one for one is good. Connor, if you're looking at the Falcons here on offense, they've only put up 20 points so far in the second half. Right. What do they need to do to keep pushing on offense and really stop Christian Brothers on defense?
Well, I think offensively we need to take a lot smarter of shots. I think we've taken a fair number of shots, but unfortunately a lot of them haven't fallen because they just haven't been the best possible one to shoot for. Defensively, slowing things up and getting the rebounds, I think, is the most important, most crucial thing for the Falcons right now.
And so the Falcons still down 14, 63-49. But again, right. If you look at it on the stat sheet, a lot of the stats are very similar.
Right.
Christian Brothers 26 points in the paint, Falcons 24. Christian Brothers now with 28 points on the paint.
Yes.
Christian Brothers 16 second chance points, Falcons 15 second chance points. Falcons 18 bench points and Christian Brothers 13 bench points. It really comes down to the 3 points that have been made for each team. Christian Brothers have made 9 of their threes to the Falcons just making 3 of their own.
Right.
That 3 off, and now the Falcons now 3 of 16 from behind the arc as Cam takes one and he gets his to fall. So the Falcons finally get a 3 to fall, and it looked like they're going to have a man-to-man press, but instead they're going to play a 3-man press at half court. Falcons switch back to man-to-man now, and a dangerous attempt there to steal that ball by Wade Lohman. He does end up knocking it out, but that's something you like to see from the defense aggressive.
That was good. I like that 1-2 press that they're going on with. Trying to trap them in the corners, too.
Right.
Yeah. Now they have a big man up top for them.
Falcons can't afford to foul at all here. And the big man will take the three. This one is no good. But there it is again. The guard for Christian Brothers, Adrian Rustaz, getting inside, but the Falcons able to pull away with the rebound. Yeomans outside to Copeland. He will lose it, and a block will be called on Christian Brothers. So Cam Copeland will head to the line, 1-1. Falcons really have to start making these if they want to get back inside the game. And a foul called right there on Zach Jackson. That's an over for the back. But those free throws right there are the ones that the Falcons can't afford to miss, because despite having a 13-point lead still, Christian Brothers is still being very aggressive on defense, which has at times led to the 1-1s for the Falcons. So those ones, they really got to start making.
For sure.
Christian Brothers again with another open three. This one is off the side. Both guys for the Falcons go after the same rebound. Copeland looking to move it inside. A good spin move there. Finds Zach Jackson. And Lee loses possession of the ball, regains it, and goes up for two on the reverse layup. And the Falcons again, like you said, setting up for that 3-man press at half court. And a foul called right there on the far side of the court. Michael Fuller with the block. That's his second foul of the game. 5:11 now to go in the game. Falcons still down 11. Cannot really let Christian Brothers start scoring like they did early on in the second half.
No.
And great ball movement there from Christian Brothers. And there it is right there. That's what they did at the beginning of the second half that got them to this lead with what they have right now. Michael Fuller going in strong. He kisses it off the glass for 2 points. Keeps it back to a 12-point game. And if you sit down and look at the conference right here, this is essentially a big conference game for both teams, because Christian Brothers comes into this game 4-3 in the conference. Falcons 3-3. So only half a game apart between each other as Christian Brothers turns the ball over right there. But like we were saying, only a half game separation between these two teams, and if the Falcons were able to win it, they would moved to 4-3 in the conference. Christian Brothers to 4-4.
Right.
So it's a big game for both teams when you look at the conference standings.
Definitely. Copeland with a drive and a dish that fails, but.
So the Falcons give the ball right back after forcing a turnover. And another open three right there. And again, the same guy that has done it all game long, Luke Rudy, hitting those threes from the corner now with 12 points for Christian Brothers. He's been the guy for them out on the corner.
Most definitely.
A big dunk right there from Wade Lomans, trying to get some sort of momentum back into this offense.
And that's bringing the crowd back into it too, for sure.
Very big time. And a foul called right there on Zach Jackson. That was good ball movement there from Christian Brothers. So we head to another media timeout. 3:38 to go in the game. Falcons still in it. Not down too much yet. Down 71-58. We'll be right back. So back here in Trustmark Arena, as Christian Brothers will head to the line. And Connor, if you look at it, the game's still not out of reach yet.
No,
it's only 71-58. You still have over 3.5 minutes to go in the game.
Still a lot of time left.
There's still a lot of time left. And things like this right here. The missed free throws for Christian Brothers are huge for the Falcons.
Oh, yeah.
Second free throw's up. This one, it falls. But still only a 14-point game. It's very doable for the Falcons offense.
If I were them right now, I would just look to cut, to chip away at the lead as much as I could and, you know, keep going from there. But
Micah Fuller with a three. Good.
That's good.
That's exactly what you're talking about right there. Chipping away at the lead. Falcons now playing that full court press.
And now it's at 11.
Falcons need to play good aggressive defense here. Cannot allow Christian Brothers to score. And they find that corner shot again. They're able to miss it this time. The Falcons with a
good
huge rebound.
By Jackson.
Here comes Wade Lomans.
Against.
And an intentional foul called right there. And Coach Danny Young said it best. Adrian Rutstaz has to make a play on the ball for it to be a common foul, but he did not. Just went straight at Wade Lohman, which essentially makes it an intentional foul and sends him to the line.
Lohman's going to tape up a bit before heading to the line.
I know they call it intentional, but what is that? once you throw him in the bowl, yeah, but I think that Wade has to shoot it. I don't think that Wade has to shoot it. Yeah, because he was fine. Two free throws in the ball.
So Wade Lohmans to the line. First free throw is up and good. He'll have a second opportunity here. Like we were just saying a second ago, these are what's huge in the Falcons' essential comeback. Second free throw's up. In and out. But because it was an intentional foul, after those two free throws, the Falcons still are able to regain possession so they can still cut into this lead right here.
Oh, for sure, yeah.
Copeland will set up shot for the Falcons at the top. Micah Fuller trapped down low. Has to find some way to get it off. He does to Lohman at the top. 12 seconds on the shot clock. Lohman with a good look to Jackson. Oh, he goes for the big dunk. Not able to get it to fall. This place would have gone crazy if Zach Jackson was able to land that dunk. Number 44, Jacob Lyons.
Like
hurt right there for Christian Brothers.
Tears into our bench.
That would have been massive if Zach Jackson was able to nail that dunk. And the bench was already standing up going crazy because they thought he had it. However, although...
It is not a good day for free throws.
It's really not. It's really not. But although Jacob Lyons got hurt on that play, he still did foul Jack Yeoman, hence why he's at the line right now shooting two, and he gets the second one to fall. But as you said, the Falcons need to make more of these free throws. Now under 2.5 minutes to go in the game, still down by 9. And a foul called right there on Yeomans.
Seems a little early to start fouling. I don't know if free throws at the line are really what they're needing right now. But
that's the last thing the Falcons can afford to do right now.
Yeah.
Second free throw's up. This one falls. And Aiden Rustaz, the small guard that's really chopped away at the Falcons' defense so far tonight, checks back into the game. He'll be guarding Micah Fuller. The Falcons done very well on offense lately, though, finding a way to get points on the board. Fuller to Yeomans. Yeomans over to Copeland. Cam
Copeland
goes up.
Lohman now.
Lohman does get fouled. He'll head to the line. If you think about it, both these are essentially must-makes.
Yes, yeah.
First free throw's up and good. Able to make this one that cuts the lead down to 9, which the Falcons could essentially come down and just make three quick threes. Not necessarily quick, but could make three threes.
Right.
To make it a tie ball game, as the Falcons are now called timeout. So we'll stay with you throughout the rest of this game because it's a close game now with 2 minutes and 10 seconds left to go. If you're the Falcons, as Coach Danny Young has been preaching to his team for the past couple minutes, you can't afford to foul at all.
No.
Especially to Joe Lavery, who has 30 points for Christian Brothers. So if you're the Falcons, You're looking to press, but are you being as aggressive as you need to be? Because if you foul, Christian Brothers is still heading to the line.
Right, for sure.
So if you're the Falcons here, are you going to play that full court man-to-man press? Are you going to meet him at the top of the key? What do you think would be the best option for the Falcons in this situation?
I think that the long press would be best to try to disrupt the offense for as long as you can. I don't know if I was them, I would get into fouling as heavily as with this much time left,
right.
I guess, because you know all that is going to do is create foul shot opportunities, which Christian Brothers has shown to knock them down. So
Christian Brothers 9 of 11
yeah.
from the line tonight, so shooting very well from the free throw line. But then again, if the Falcons, what we assume, run that long full court press, you have to be careful on the backside of the court, because a couple times they've been able to push it down right below the goal for an easy two
for
points.
Sure, yeah.
So 2:10 to go in the game. Falcons down 74-65. Micah Fuller, Zach Jackson, Cam Copeland, Wade Lohman, and Jack Yeomans on the court for the Falcons. And this is a rotation that you look at for the Falcons is essentially their quick rotation.
Yes.
Oh, the fastest five guys they can put on the court.
A lot of speed in there right now.
And the Falcons do play that full court
and
press.
He's dropped.
And good ball movement there from Christian Brothers. And the Christian Brothers will now try and run time off of the clock. Falcons might have to start fouling soon, but not yet. And there's the foul right there by Lohmans. First free throw is up and good. This is number 33, Adam Dyball, at the line. He has 9 so far today, 2 for 2 from the free throw line. Second free throw is up and good, so he has now reached 10 points. Christian Brothers now with 4 different players that have reached double-digit scoring tonight.
Wow.
Good move right there by Micah Fuller, though, and he cuts into this lead yet again. Micah Fuller quietly having a very good game for the Falcons. Falcons trying to trap over there again in the corner. And Micah Fuller, a smart foul there, you would say.
Yeah, I think so.
The only thing that's bad about that is they send the guy that they don't want to send to the line. That's
exactly.
Joe Oliveri, who is leading all scorers tonight with 30 points, and he's also 5 of 5 from the free throw line.
Mm-hmm.
Free throw is up and good. And makes both free throws. The Falcons, it doesn't seem that Christian Brothers is going to miss their free throws, so the Falcons are going to have to find a way to maybe steal the ball without having to send Christian Brothers to the line. Micah Fuller having to make a dangerous pass to Zach Jackson. Gets it off. Jackson goes up. No good. Christian Brothers with the rebound. And a foul right away by Micah Fuller, which sends Christian Brothers to the line yet again. This time, it'll be number 20, Nick Dyfel. First free throw is up, and this one is good. And Dyfel, again, another guy for Christian Brothers who shoots from the free throw line very well. He is now 5 of 5 from the line tonight. Christian Brothers now 13 of 16 from the line for the night. Second free throw up and rolls in off the back iron. And Christian Brothers will call a timeout there. So 80-67, minute 22 to go in the game. The Falcons have been taking it inside, being very aggressive, trying to draw fouls early. Do you think if you're the Falcons here with this much with this less time left in the game, they need to start looking behind the arc more, down 13?
Yeah, I would say so. Yeah. I think that overall, I mean, they had a few different opportunities to bring the game back, but at this point, it might just be stopping the bleeding as much as they can.
This might be a situation where you see guys like Tyler Updike.
Right.
And guys like that who can shoot the three, check back into the game.
Yeah, for sure.
And checking in for the Falcons will be the same rotation. So Zach Jackson, Wade Lohman, Micah Fuller, Cam Copeland, and Jack Yeomans again, the Falcons sticking with the fast-paced five that they need on the court.
We'll see what we can do with that.
Christian Brothers now essentially switching to a man-to-man at half court.
Right,
Cam Copeland, able to find the lane, but makes not the best looking pass. He looks like he could have gone up with that for two instead of trying to pass it off right there. Falcons still looking to trap in the corner. Falcons not looking to foul. Still trapping. Almost a backcourt violation there. Five seconds on the shot clock. Christian Brothers still hasn't gotten a good look yet. And there's the small guard again. Aiden Rustaz not able to get the points to follow this time. Falcons still down 13. 30 seconds to go in the game. Cam Copeland passes off to Yeomans. He makes a good move. Step over three. No good. This one's long. Wade Loman again with a great rebound. Goes up. This two is good. 80 to 69 now. Falcons still looking to press.
If we can take away any positives from today, it would be Wade Loman's game.
A big time. And so the Falcons just, they didn't play awful today. They didn't play a bad basketball game.
No.
But it's just the offense of Christian Brothers being able to find ways around the perimeter that really helped them win this basketball game.
I agree.
So a tough loss at home for the Falcons. They moved to 7-10 on the season. Just their second home loss of the year, though. Falcons do face Lee University next. That will be on January 17th. And then return for a two-game homestand against AUM, Auburn Montgomery, and Valdosta State. Lee, their next opponent, currently 9-6 on the season. Valdosta State leading the conference at 13-2, but Auburn Montgomery only 5-10. So a tough stretch coming up for the Falcons, but like we said, not a bad game for the Falcons, but just a little choppy throughout the whole game.
For sure.
So the Falcons take a tough loss here, 80-69, but look to bounce back later on this week against Lee University. The Falcons fall 80-69. For Connor Ryan, I'm Brett Batchelor. Thank you all for joining us, and we'll see you all next time.
Thank you.
Now my girlfriend's coming to get me. I was just saying if you were walking, it's apparently pouring rain down. So.
Oh, is it really?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, though.
Yeah, you're good.